right, so this is the World of Darkness introduction to Changeling game we're running. Listeners, today we got me, Devin, running again. To my left, we got...
Nicole.
She's playing a Changeling by the name of...
Remy.
Who is a... What's her seeming in Kith? For people who care.
Elemental and mannequin.
Awesome. Across from me, we got...
Kevin,
who is playing
Hector Wisp,
and he's basically a werewolf, right?
Yep.
Awesome. And to another friend of ours called Nicole, but for clarity's sake, we'll call her Gayle. Say hi, Nicole, or Gayle.
Hi.
Hi.
There you go. and you are playing a changeling who is?
She is a hunter heart, and she's a beast. Basically, she's a kitty girl.
Ah, yes, the cat girl. Perfect. Okay, so you're not going to hear much of Kevin for the first part of this game, as his character isn't going through hedge stuff. We're going to try and do junk where they're still captured by the true fae and have to escape the horrors of Arcadia. And this is kind of just like an intro session, kind of light on rules. And we're just getting our head around the fluff. A lot of us here have various knowledge of Changeling, but it's very patchwork right now. I think I'm reading the book from cover to cover right now just to get a handle on it as sessions go by. Changeling. Themes of Changeling. Being kidnapped, weird abusive relationships by alien abductors, escaping, being different now after you've been abused, which has weird, creepy overtones in the real world, psychology-wise. And also things being cool and stuff. Yeah. So, Nicole, Gayle, could you please tell us a bit about your character and how she was kidnapped by the Fae?
When she was 15 years old, she went to a mall, and there was a pet shop and a really cute little cat there, and she decided she wanted it, so she put it in her jacket and walked out, and that's the last thing she remembers before she ended up in Arcadia.
All right. And Nicole.
I have not thought of how my character was kidnapped. I know I was, like, really young at the time, like 6.
Okay, that's fairly standard age to be kidnapped.
Yeah, I don't remember much about why or, like, what was going on when I was kidnapped. I'll have to think of that later. I was just
that's fine. Character. That's fine. You might have hard times remembering that kind of stuff, too. Like, that's fairly common for changelings.
Especially that young.
Yeah. Yeah, but you remember enough about your home to formulate a breakout plan or to take the opportunity when it comes up. So I think we'll start with Gayle and then we'll move into Nicole because they actually have captors or jailers that are kind of connected, actually.
My character isn't 15 now. She's somewhere between 20 and 25. But I had wanted it to only have been maybe a couple of weeks in real time. So she aged quite a bit before coming back to the real world.
So a few weeks have gone by and she's 25.
Yeah, basically.
Fair enough.
Same for me, actually.
Perfect.
I wasn't planning, like, if I could have stayed in it, I was assuming that there was a fetch. And yeah, for real life time, it's only been like a couple weeks or whatever.
So you both were kidnapped around the same time and just made your way back.
Yeah.
So it'd be difficult maybe for those characters to even get back to their life as they are no longer who they were.
Yeah, like my character now is probably like
more so than 16, just their change.
Yeah, 16 or 18 now. Like she's basically a teenager / grown up. Yeah, she was like 6 when she was kidnapped.
Are you both just 25? Is that like a nice even?
Yeah, sure, whatever. 25. Right. No.
That's hilarious. Because you need to convince your parents that, you know, it's you were kidnapped, it's been 9 years. It's like,
it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, well, we got a 6-year-old right here. What do we need you for? Fuck. You already... What, do you have college debt now? Did you go to college in the Fae world? Get the fuck out of here. You don't have any work experience? You're a drain. Okay, so your character, Gayle, is named Sly?
Yep.
Perfect. So, in Arcadia, time and space have literally no meaning. Everything is kind of at the whim of your fairy overlords. They basically shape the world around them to their whims and to their desires at the time. Fairies are alien and horrible and beautiful, and they like passions, but they don't really have any feelings of their own. They're sociopaths through and through. There's no way for them to ever consider the viewpoint of another person. So, at some times, it can be really nice to hang out with them. Other times, it's going to be a never-ending nightmare. And you have no reference to when it starts or ends, because your mind can't comprehend the true form of a fairy realm. So it's just constant flashes and images and memories of things that could have happened in sequence or might not have happened yet. And doubting what is and is not real in some sort of Alice in Wonderland, twisting, roiling chaos world. But on one particular day, you remember a certain string of events. It just kind of pops into your head as you're going about whatever routine your what are they called? Truffey? Your gentry?
Keepers.
You remember a series of events leading up to your keepers as you just kind of meditated on it in the morning. It was you being different, being younger, being normaler, being less, more happy, and yet less, having less of an exciting life. Going into a store where they sell animals or food, and you taking one and ending up here. And you're like, oh yeah, that happened to me. Yeah, that wasn't a dream. That was real, probably. But it really resonates with you for some reason. And it starts the chain of events off that links you back to remembering that the world before now was a thing. It wasn't just something someone told you once. What kind of things does the True Fae make you do? Does your keeper make you do?
There are hunts regularly, and Sly is part of those hunts. And sometimes it is other people who have been kidnapped, and we go and get them, or sometimes it is other beasts from the pack that we know. Sometimes just animals, or creatures. That's one of the things. But mostly there's a lot of sitting around and eating and just lounging and being critters.
So you're normally like some sort of cat monster animal when your keeper's hanging out with you? Kind of like a pet?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, all of the other changelings there, I imagine, are beasts. So yeah. It's kind of like
some are beasts, you know, so there's quite a few darklings, like just lore keepers or things that dwell under the grounds of the estate that your keeper has. It's like a fox hunting club, like a Victorian era one that goes out into an enormous forest covered in trees that eventually give way to thorns and roses, higher than any skyscraper. Where it's fun to hunt. Because it's so treacherous, so dangerous, so unpleasant. Your keeper, which usually takes the form or the idea of this group of like Victorian era fox hunting men, like gentlemen's club people, but just with different affectations and clothing and weird kind of not quite human things about them. Like some of them have two faces, one on the back of their head, one on the front, and they'll just snap backwards and forward whenever they're switching between personalities. Your keeper is a group that splits itself into like a little fox hunting group, a lodge that lounges about and has fun with it. They all unanimously seem bored with it. The last few hunts, they basically called it in the middle and said, just let it go. Whatever. We'll do something else. And they're just completely done with this whole thing. And you see them making plans and sending letters, which is more like they'll grab butterflies and like stamp something on their wings and then fold them in half and stuff them in a bag for one of the darklings to take in like a mail bag and like skirt off the property. And yeah, they just seem really agitated the last couple hunts. You can't say days, months, or years, just the last few hunts.
Imagine that would make my character first kind of sad, because this is like going on the hunts, as much as she probably has conflicted feelings about, like, okay, sometimes we're hunting my friends.
Sometimes we're hunting me.
Sometimes we're hunting me. But it could be me. But she's also kind of like, well, that's the only break in our monotony of just kind of
existing. One of the collective groups of huntsmen gets mail back one day, like butterfly wings, snaps it open. The butterfly's like squirming around, just kind of like reads the petals on its back. And I just toss it into the fire casually. And they're just talking, they're like, that seems like a cool idea. And some of them don't speak any language you understand, but other ones speak English, or other ones speak, like, French or German. It's weird. And you can understand some of what they're saying if you've been around them long enough. And it's like, well, let's try it here. We don't need to go out for this. We don't need to leave this state. Yes, yes. And they point to you. You there! Sly! Come here, girl.
She goes over and kind of looks nervously to the other ones.
All right, one of them reaches down and has something behind his back, and he's about to take it out and puts a hat on you, like a newspaper cap. And they grab one of the larger hunting rabbit predators and puts it down next to you. Another changeling who's like super big and bulky, and you can see under the rabbit body, it's basically like a button-up disguise. There's a dude under there who's rabbit-like. He's like, okay. And they put like a little helmet on him and give him like a combat knife that he like touches with this little pod suit that he can't really deal with. And it's like, ah, Mrs. Sly, okay. You are a young German resistance fighter in the French Navy or something. And someone's like, wah, 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 wah. Yes, yes, yes. And Rabbitins is a posh wine distributor soldier, mercenary soldier. And go! No, it's working. This is good. It's stoicism. It's fine. Stoicism is like a
German trait.
It's a German trait. Yes, Germans. We love Germans. Remember their blimps?
I'm gonna reach over and just try to get the knife from the Rabbitins.
Oh, Sly's taking the weapon! Sly's taking the weapon! The guy in the bunny suit, Mr. Bunnytins, that's not his name, just kind of like tries to paw at it. And they're like, it's a struggle! It's a struggle of ideals!
So
kill him! Bored. He's from East Germany! Do it!
They're so bored.
Yes, this isn't working. Run along. I take back the newspaper cap. This is garbage. Throws it in the fire. Okay. We'll write the letter. This is fine. We have a solution. And they kind of just make a shooing motion at you. Yeah. One of them throws a toffee at your head.
I'll grab it. I still have my knife, unless they take it away.
No, they don't think to take it away.
All right, I have a knife.
Yeah! It's fairly modern. Like, it's something you get, like an outlet mall in, like, Toronto. You know, like a knife store that, like, teenagers would buy knives from. Be like, oh, awesome. Like, it has like a stupid, like, elephant thing on the end or whatever.
What?
Like an wonderful elephant. It looks cheap as shit. It's not a German knife.
And it's my new shiny.
Yeah. Some of the other entities that live in the mansion, some are changelings, some are just, you know, Arcadian creatures that live in the safety of the estate. You know, they get together in their the place where they eat. Food doesn't really have a meaning here, but it's more of like, it's more of going through the motions, going through the story of eating. It's like, now you've eaten, now you're full. It doesn't really matter if you do it or not, as long as it happens once in a while. And yeah, everyone seems disconcerted about how they're not going on hunts anymore. Oh, and you pulled a knife on Mr. Bunnykins or something? They're unclear about what any of this means. They're pestering the goblin over there that does mail. It's like, surely you read their mail? I would never read their mail. Do you know what they did to the last goblin? They turned him into my mailbag. There's like a face on it. It's like, please, read the mail. I'm gonna break.
Going to listen to the chatter, I guess, and see if anybody actually says anything that is useful.
It's like, well, where did you go? Well, I guess that's not a secret. There wasn't like a stamp sealing where I went. They didn't put wax on that. And the bank's like, they'll put wax on your mouth, traitor. Oh yeah, I went to the other estate for the Winterflame Lord. You know, the Winterflame Lord. He has all the metal and the lightning at his estate. And the dolls. No, I don't know. Haven't been there? We hunted there a few times. People are really just concerned because your keeper never really interacts with their keepers. And now he is. And that never bodes well. That's change. Change is awful.
Change is scary.
I don't like change!
Mm-hmm.
It's like, what if they don't hunt anymore? Well, we'll have a lot more to do.
No. If they don't hunt anymore, they won't need to feed us. Haven't you seen the trophy room?
Adventure.
And it is kind of worrisome, I suppose, to her, but she's also fairly comfortable.
Yeah.
So it's... There's sort of a nagging worry that she should be more worried, but she's not really.
Alright.
It's probably gonna be fine.
Ah, it's probably good. So we'll cut to... What's your character's name, Nicole, again?
Remy.
You don't really remember how you left home, but you remember home was good. And this is not as good. Like, it's fun, but only to a point. Your keeper is a little less abstract. He is a paunchy white guy in his mid-30s with, like, a patchy neck beard and, like, some snaggle teeth. And he looks really dumpy by standards that anyone would assume a person could look dumpy. He wears a velvet blue business suit with, like, a tie. And then he wears a red sequin vest over top of it. And then he wears a large black trench coat with, like, just the gaudiest type of metal, like, pinned to it. Like, chains that go to wallets and, like gears and steampunky garbage that you'd see at, like...
The anime convention?
Anime convention. Any LARP hangout. You know, that certain type of teenager who hasn't gotten over it yet... Or has it transcended into a real, actual subculture? Yeah, he lured you out of your home and into his domain and changed you. He calls himself the director at this point in time, but you've heard from your others like you that he's gone through many different names. He used to be the poet, he used to be the bard, he used to be the playwright, and right now he's the director. And you're in one of his... films, one of his directions, one of his moving entertainment things, which is you're in a theater, bigger than any theater probably should be, with far less seating than it probably should have. It has like multiple levels and parts of the stage that are hidden from the audience where the play continues to go on in the background and stuff. And, like, there's parts of that shift around and entire walls can be flipped open like it's a giant book revealing complete sets in between the covers where they're, like, changelings with their backs against the wall because it's kind of thin in there. And you're in one of his many acts of one of the many acts of his most recent thing that can last for a lot of scenes. And you've probably gone through, like, 100 scenes of this, one after another. He seems to make it up as he goes along or consults, like, a manuscript. And your role is to be the shop girl, who is also a Satanist, who's in love with a snake that works as an orange salesman in the basement. That's your motivation, by the way, he says. Not that that's what you are, that's your entire motivation.
So I'm a Satanist in love with a snake.
Who sells oranges in the basement.
Wait, snake sells oranges or I sell oranges?
The snake sells oranges, you're a shop girl.
I could also sell oranges.
No, you're a shop girl, not an orange seller.
What kind of shop is it?
It's a shop.
Person who isn't there.
It's a shop.
I'm curious.
It doesn't need to be anything else but a shop.
But what do they sell?
Shop things. It's more important about the costume. This play is really about the duality of birds than it is about what the shopkeeper is. Birds.
Does she sell birds?
No, birds have coloration, and coloration is the uniform.
But she could sell birds.
Boil you in oil. Have that one boiled in oil. He says to nothing. Maybe just one of his books is talking at him. He's like, I don't want criticism from you. Okay. So, in this scene, we have a French resistance boy in a paper hat coming to... you're going to shoot him. Okay? And... Go!
You'll never take him alive!
You don't have a gun. You just pointed him and...
Yeah.
Alright, he's like, oh no! I didn't get a chance to read any of my lines! And he falls over. The director's all like, that's gold. That's gold right there. There's an audience at this point, by the way. It's a bunch of men who have white body paint on and, like, no real features, except their face is the happy sad mask, and it's in black and white. So, like, the happy mask is black.
Tragedy and comedy.
Yeah, the tragedy and comedy, but it's very simplified, and the sad one isn't sad because it's like that. It's because that entire part of the face is flipped upside down, so the eyes near the mouth of the happy one. And they're all sitting there with their gloved hands clapping in unison. Just maybe 100 of them. Just in unison clapping.
I raise my hand kind of stiffly and wave.
He's like, alright. Now in the next scene, your heart is broken. So you cry. Do it.
I'm gonna throw myself off the counter.
all the mannequins pick up like a wooden rag and like put it to their eye and then put it down. It's like, alright. Perfect. And then a little veil goblin comes, like a darkling, with like a veil bag with a face on it, and he delivers a butterfly to him and like doesn't make eye contact, and he's like, ooh. Alright, burn it to the ground! Burn it to the ground! And a bunch of ogres come out with big barrels of kerosene and just start spraying it everywhere.
Actual kerosene?
Yeah.
Okay, it's not part of the play. Is this part of the play?
Oh, well, take five, smoke break! And then he, like, lights a match off his hand and throws it on the theater.
They'll scurry away?
Many people scurry away for the smoke break. Smoke fills the theater. all the mannequins are clapping as the kerosene starts hitting their bodies, and like the wood and plaster and lacquer that they're made of starts bubbling up and catching, and they start burning alive. One of them holds up a sign that says "Encore" as it melts and explodes from heat combustion. So what do you do during your smoke break? Everyone's huddled, in a corner of the theater where the fire is least around them because there's no exit. The exit door's over there, but it's closed. No one opens the emergency exit.
I was gonna say, I'm gonna go up the emergency
exit. Nah, it's closed. People don't go through there. You can't go through there.
Wait, I can't open the door?
No, you can't open it.
It's for aesthetic value.
Yeah, but there's like a corner, like right near the entrance, like right near where the director's chair is, where the fire isn't spreading, and you guys are hanging out there. Some of them, you guys have like fruits and like scripts that are hanging out to each other and just reading to look busy, look like they're invested in the play. I think the duality of birds is important to this. You're a sycophant. You're all sycophants, right, director?
I'm so glad that shop wasn't filled with birds. That would have been a tragedy.
What about my death scene? Wasn't it great? It's like you're bleeding from the chest. What? No. Oh, I can't stop the bleeding,
I lift up my hand, and, like, look at the gun just a hand. No, I look at my gun hand, though, like, it's just my hand, but, like, I do it in the shape of a gun. I'm just, like, kind of, like, have that
smile. They're, like, using scripts to staunch the bleeding.
I'll, like, pretend to take out a bandage, and, like, put it on his chest.
You're miming, you can't mime in a play! How will people know what you're feeling?
I take out my gun again. My finger. That
I can't
obviously
just say
worked
what you
as a
feel.
Gun.
That makes me feel angry.
I'm daring you to solve my method acting.
After a while, carpenters and different type of fairies that are good at building rip apart the ashes of the stage and the audience room and start rebuilding. Not fast, but you don't really have a concept of time, so it basically happens in a scene swipe. Like, you actually see a void coming out of the corner of your eye, swiping through, erasing people, and getting you too. And then you're sitting in a chair as the stage is being finished. The scene swipe comes and erases you, and then you're stepping in the next scene. So the theater's been changed to be very squared off. Like, there's like, it's like half of a hexagon room. So, like, you know, there's like panels everywhere. There's, like, it's big enough that you could probably hold, like, a house in it, like, a couple houses. And there's, like, little things being set up, roads going everywhere with directions. They have little stages set up and little shops. And, like, they have, like, little footprints everywhere for where your blocking's supposed to be. Someone hoists up a giant candle to be the sun. Someone's walking by with what looks like a dragon in a cage, like an actual dragon that's, like, scraping at the cage and stuff and breathing fire. And they're getting into place, and the director is like shaking hands with a bunch of hunting people, like Victorian era gentlemen's club hunters.
You're
the trophy room, and you're there. You're in a giant feeder. The seats are Well, you were at dinner, and now you're in a giant feeder.
This is not a place I've been.
There's a bunch of your changelings there in animal form, but now they look more like people in like giant animal suits. Like a really bad play costumes. Including you, you're in like a giant cat suit, even though you're also a cat girl, but you're not a cat anymore.
Okay.
Like you take the giant, you know, cotton mascot head off, and it's, you know, you're in person head form, but you have like, you know, your cat girl stuff.
Yeah.
They're like, costuming, people are like measuring, you know, they're applying makeup to the cat head.
This doesn't make sense.
This is different. This is change.
This is weird. I do not like... Is there a couch somewhere I can tear up?
There are, no. But there are, like, velour chairs in the seating area. There's, like, 100 of those mannequin guys. These have been crudely repainted and, like, tape and, like, nails have been put into them so they can, like, still do their thing and clap.
Who's nearest to me?
Nicole is.
Remy.
I'm going to, like,
What does Remy look like?
Remy looks like a ball-jointed doll with... eyes that are definitely too large. She has a kind of wooden smile on at almost all times. She has like both fake like blush marks on her cheeks, like little like drawn on eyelashes. She has long blondish hair, like kind of like a brown, almost blonde hair. Yeah, she's wearing at the moment a shop girl's outfit, I'm assuming.
Yeah, costume has wardrobe hasn't been by yet.
Yeah, so I'm wearing, you know, a dress with like an apron. Striped apron. Probably has, like, a name tag. Probably... I don't know if the name tag has my name on it.
No, it just says name.
Yeah.
What does Sly look like?
She can hear say, could say slut, by the way.
She has, black cat ears and a puffy black tail, and she's got claws in her fingers, but they're retractable, so they're not, like, super far out right now. And... she's 6 feet tall.
Well, I guess that's something I should also mention. My character's not very tall. She's like, she's like just 5 feet. Like
okay.
Just.
180 centimeters?
No. That's like 150 centimeters, I think.
And she's covered in like sort of hieroglyphic looking tattoos. But yeah, she's gonna reach over to... what's your character's name?
Remy.
Remy. Okay. She'll reach over to Remy and, like, just start making muffins on her shoulder with her claws.
What?
Like, doing the cat kneading thing, making muffins.
Okay.
Yeah. My skin's, just on her shoulder,
my
making muffins.
Kind of, plasticky textured. So it's not quite soft like normal flesh should be. And I'm much paler than it should be. But yeah, okay.
Her claws are pretty sharp, so she's gonna poke ya. But she's probably... she's not really thinking, like, this is people. Because you look like a mannequin. So, yeah, she's just kind of... and she's not even looking at you. She's just kind of, like, putting her claws on your shoulders, like...
I stand there for a minute, let it happen. And then I kind of duck down a bit and turn so that my arm's, like, just out from where it was. Tilt my head.
Reach further over and keep doing it.
I'll move away again.
Then I'll look over.
Yeah, I'll, like, tilt my head with, like, wooden smile.
Oh.
Hello.
Sorry about that.
Oh, I'm done. Are you here for the play?
I ain't got any idea why I'm here at all. Where are we?
We're in the theater. Do you know what your role is yet? I haven't gotten my new one.
I don't know. I hunt things.
Oh, it's going to be a hunting play. I don't usually have those kinds of roles. I hope I'm not the prey.
I'm gonna kind of look around, like, if there's someone here with more sense in their words.
Why would you ever think that'd be the case? Well, perfect, Nicole.
See?
There.
It's hot, it's hot. There's something in between you.
Demolition.
Did you say that in character?
No.
Okay. I was like, I don't know how to react. That was so random.
Demolition.
Right. I'm gonna, like, take croissant off, like, the cast table and, like, eat it, but it's not a real croissant, so I'm just kind of, like, doll-handing it.
Going through the motions.
Kind of, like, doll-handing it, just like,
I'll, like, reach out and tap on it with a claw.
It's made of clay.
So, this place is for plays.
Yes.
And you're in plays.
Yes. So are you, I'm assuming.
No, I ain't supposed to be in plays.
Well, I don't think you're an audience. That's the audience.
Oh.
One of them doesn't have an arm because it melted off and it's just half clapping in air.
That's the sound. Of one hand clapping.
So, who's in charge around here?
Oh, that's the director.
The director.
I think it's the producer, director.
He's a director. It's sort of the D.
Interchangeable.
The director. He's...
He's over there talking to the five, like, to a nebulous amount of hunter, fox hunters.
He's over there.
And when I look over there, I actually look relieved to see the fox hunters, because I was like, oh, okay, something I know.
It's not just me.
This is okay. All right. So, when does the play start?
It hasn't started yet.
Well, obviously, because we're not on the stage.
It'll open at curtain call.
Curtain call. When's that? Is there a bell? There
are one? I pause for a second, like I'm thinking. I kind of tilt my head, like, the question doesn't make sense, just like...
Like, does it happen when there's a bell or a horn, or, like, does somebody say go, or blow a whistle, or...
The director does someone start running? Say action.
Action.
Usually.
I haven't heard that one.
That's usually how it starts.
You hear a loud ringing sound, and people are like, clear out of the way, clear out of the way! And you guys are in front of the stage, right? A giant pane of clear glass descends down in front of the stage, in front of where, like, all the stage plays stuff would go.
Oh.
And then a bunch of people bring in a giant gilded cage that doesn't have bars, but it has, like, you know, four corner bars that basically go over a roof. And it has, like, a bunch of, like, obscure dancing directions on the floor. And, like, various bells and, like, wheels and stuff on the four bars itself. And they just drag it onto a dais that's in front of the stage, but at level with it. So you can see straight onto it. Yeah, and it has, like, little stairs going so that someone from the audience can climb up. And they start throwing, like, yarn and string under the stage. From the podium.
Was I the only animal person here?
No, there's a few others. There's a bunny
guy. Okay, I thought there was others.
Bunny guy's over there. There's a squirrel. There's a few hunting foxes.
Okay.
The hunting foxes are... they range from tall to small, but most of them look kind of hard-edged, have scars over them, and look like they smoke. And, like, they actually have, like, blunderbusses and stuff. Like, they're the favorites. Sometimes they go on hunts outside of the grounds. Sometimes they go on hunts outside of the hedge. Sometimes they hunt free-range animals. Sometimes those free-range animals go to the trophy room. They're hunters. Like, loyalists.
Privateers?
No, privateers, I think, do their own thing. These guys are just the like, three or four changelings that her Trufei uses to hunt down changelings for fun.
So, like, they're trying to throw, like, yarn in there up there, trying to get the cable?
No, they're throwing yarn under the stage, like it's cables or, like, it's lighting wires.
So what do you use that for?
This is all very new.
This is all very new.
So what do you use it for?
A bunch of candles are put at the base of the screen to give it a bit of a glare. So the screen itself kind of glares a bit when you look straight onto it to look at the stage.
And she does ask again. She says, what do you use it for? But, like, she doesn't realize that it being new means you have no idea what it means. Like, you should know. You're a professional here.
Well, they put a shield in front of the stage. Maybe first 5 rows will get lit?
Is it a whale?
There might be.
That shield might seal in the theater so I can fill it with water so it can be underwater. I'm underwater scene.
Exactly.
Okay. So we just wait.
Usually. We haven't gotten our lines. Have you gotten your lines yet?
No lines! There'll be no lines! The direct producer runs by and he just starts giving you guys little pamphlets. No lines! This is all free form! No lines!
What does that mean?
It means we have to improvise. I'm... Okay. Okay, we can do that.
Do you want to read your pamphlet?
We can do that.
Yeah.
We'll, like, open it up.
Your pamphlet's like, you run a shop.
Oh, okay.
What does mine say?
When music selection 2 runs, you're going to be angry. When music selection 3 runs, you're going to be sad. Music selection 72 runs, you'll engage in secret dialogue. See back of pamphlet. The back of the pamphlet's like, secret dialogue should be something like, and then just kind of trails off like you never finished it.
this isn't so new. this makes sense. Okay. 2 means angry. 3 means...
I'll look at it again.
Oh, it's changed. Because the ink's not all still wet.
Oh.
What's wrong?
I missed it.
You missed it?
I messed it.
You missed it?
I messed it. It's a mess.
Oh. So, clean it up.
I'll, like, try to, like, rub it to try.
Oh,
like,
no!
No! Now my fingers have ink on them!
My god, there's blood everywhere!
I'll, like, wipe it off in your shirt. Because, like, I'm in costume already.
Her cat suit.
Yeah.
Just gonna look at your hand right here. Wardrobe comes by and
throws you another identical suit for this role. Like, it's identical on your brain, but it's different because it's for a different role.
Oh, okay. I'll take off this apron, I'll fold it, put it down.
This apron is exactly the same as the other one, but it's kind of stiff. And, like, where it has wrinkles and stuff, it's kind of sharp.
Oh.
It's also kind of shiny.
Why is it shiny?
Just is. Yeah. Your role is, you're a bar wench. When the fight begins, make sure to brawl and take off your cat suit so people can see that you're a cat person underside, therefore showing that sometimes a book is exactly what's on the cover. And also cats.
What does that mean, I hand it to you?
Oh, you're going to be in a bar, you're going to be a bar wench, and then when the brawl happens, you have to make sure to brawl.
I thought I was cat.
Yes, but in this play, cats can have jobs, so you also have a job.
I have a job, I hunt.
Yes, but in this, that's not your job. Your job now, always my job. Your role.
I'm rolling?
No. Well, maybe. If you want to win the fight, you can roll. It doesn't really give clear instructions. You just have to make sure to fight everyone when the fight starts. And okay. Also take off your cat suit. Not now. When the fight starts. Don't fight me.
But I don't need it because I'm already a cat, right?
Yeah, but you're supposed to be a cat suit. And then you take off
the cat suit.
And then you're a cat person. And the audience knows about the duality of...
Books.
And how sometimes books are the same on the inside and the outside.
But they ain't. It's a cover. And cats. And this
pardon?
Nothing.
It's brilliant.
I don't know about that.
Don't question
it's
the director.
Brilliant.
Don't question the producer.
I don't think that it's...
It's okay. You're new. You're new. You'll understand. You'll understand.
So who are we chasing?
Nobody, unless they run in the fight, and then I guess you can chase them because you're supposed to fight everybody. And if they run, then they're trying to get away from the fight, and you're supposed to fight them. So, just be in the bar,
yeah.
And people will be like, "Oi, I want some alcohol!" And then you bring them the alcohol, and then a fight will start. And then you fight them.
Alright.
Oh, and take off your cat suit to express the duality of books. Not now! You're gonna ruin it.
I don't think it can get any worse.
You're right. It's so perfect. There's no chance you're gonna be able to ruin it. Just, you're the bar wench, and fight when the fight starts. And take off your cat suit to show that you're a cat.
Want to trade?
I'm the shop girl.
I want to be the shop girl.
No, you don't get to fight as a shop girl. You seem to like fighting.
Well, I could still fight as a shop girl.
No. No. Yeah. No.
I can fight in that.
No. No. This is the shop girl. This is the shop girl. At song 2, I'm angry.
I'm gonna try to take
it. Song... No! This is my cast.
I'm just gonna...
My cat. I'm literally like crossing my arms so you can't take off.
It's gonna get ripped.
No.
I'm sorry.
Maybe if I put on the other one, they won't notice. But this one's shiny. The other one wasn't shiny. The shininess is important. That's why it's different.
At this point, I'm just gonna turn away with my pamphlet and just look at it worriedly.
You don't have any of the instructions on the pamphlet.
It's empty now?
Oh, your pamphlet? Like, did you take her pamphlet?
No, I've got mine. She wouldn't let me have her apron. I ripped it and I gave up. I turned away.
Oh, so you just have room clothing.
Yeah.
Some of the spider wardrobe people is like... Except instead of using thread to fix it, they have like a little welding torch and they just kind of spot weld the parts of it back together. And they leave.
Peek over at you. Like, oh, good. Oops.
So the director's like, Places! Go to your blocking!
Is there a place that looks like a shop?
You have to go through a few pages of the stage. And yeah, there's a place that says shop. And there's like some footprints that match up with your feet where you're supposed to be standing exactly.
I'll stand there exactly.
I'm gonna follow her.
Okay, you're in the shop, not in the bar.
Yeah.
No. No. No.
What?
No.
What?
No.
What? What?
What? Did I pass the bar on my way here?
You haven't seen it yet.
Move around. Do you see it? I'm gonna stand on the things.
So from the stage where the hunters are, out of the fox hunt or not fox hunter, but the gentleman's club, they all kind of fade and get a little bit blurry, and one steps out from the crowd who looks like a 90s businessman who still has a blunderbuss and like a Russian Ushanka hat, and looks kind of like all of them, and is covered in like leaves. Alright, okay, alright.
Pop down behind the thing, getting back into place.
I'm just gonna stand next to her.
Yeah, they can't see you because there's so many layers to the stage. So he walks up to the steps to the little cage thing and just kind of...
What?
Go to the bar.
I don't know what the bar is. Isn't this a bar?
This is a shop.
Well, where is it?
You can read?
Can you show me where it is? I don't know where it is either. I'll just stay here.
Anyway, he stands in the cage and kind of just waits. And, like, from a section of the wall, it opens up. And there's a bunch of, like, band people. And, like, they're getting ready to start the soundtrack up for the play. Some of them are hummingbirds. Some of them have trumpets or, like, elephants and, like, play their own snouts with, like, brass fins on it.
There's no doors.
In where?
The theater.
They're just here. Okay. And part of the wall opened up, revealing the band. Of the theater. Like, it's a band that's playing overhead of, like, all of the people who clap.
Makes me think of those, like, old-style, like, puppet things where there's little parts that open up and there's things around it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Like the set of Alf, man. Trapdoors everywhere.
I'm gonna take her hand and, like, try to go through the pages finding the bar.
It looks like you can't leave the scene you're in. There's an invisible wall.
What's the matter? A marker or anything nearby?
There is a mark with 2 feet that look like large cloppers. A marker?
Or something.
No.
Do you have your knife, sir? Do I see your knife?
Not Pom.
No, she's in a giant kitty costume. Like a giant, dumb,
doofy,
you know, Disney kitty costume.
Give me your claw.
No.
I'm gonna fix it.
It's not broken.
No, you claw the sign.
What's wrong with the sign?
It says, shop, you have to be in the bar, so we'll make it a bar.
That's a good idea.
Yes. Give me your claw.
I'll give you my claw.
I'm gonna write...
Carve shop bar?
Bar, yeah, bar.
Let's turn the P to B. Show bar.
Subpar.
Yeah, I'm gonna write, like, end bar.
Yeah, the 90s businessman Russian guys are like, alright, so this is how the play goes, and the director's like, it's not a play! It's an interactive experience! It's great. It's really fun. They do it all the time. This'll be perfect. Alright, and 1, 2, 3! And all the lights go out, except for the candles, which are, like, glaring the screen. And then he's like, and then, like, the director runs over with, like, a large cable that's, like insulation from an HVAC system, like that big aluminum tubing, and like it's full of nothing, but he plugs it into the bottom of the stage and like throws a breaker connected to nothing, and all the lights come back on the screen, and like the sun overhead lights up with a kind of a strobe light effect. And he's like, and the text on the mirror shows up and says, press start to play. On like the giant thing in front of the stage. Like, little words come down on strings to say, press start to play. And the Russian guy, like clicks a bell, like a waiter bell in the little cage he's in. The light turns on in the stage you're in, and the whole stage shifts in its book pattern so that you guys are front and center. And, like, the music kind of makes you want to shuffle your feet and shuffle your body around a bit. You know, like an NPC. From stage left, a crude stone and wood representation of the 90s businessman, very polygon-looking, walks in, but as he's walking, it looks like he's not, like, moving under his feet. It's like he's floating forward, but his legs are moving. Like, really bad rendering. And yeah, in the cage, that businessman guy's just, like, he's walking like it's a DDR pad, and, like, he's, like, pulling pulleys and, like, doing wheel stuff. And, like, yeah, the whole stage shifts so it centers around the dude. So, like, like a Mario level, basically. And, yeah, the producer starts going through narration. Hark! You start in the... He's going through various books. The City of Nation! And it is a fine, day. He's, like, yelling into, like, a loudspeaker. All the citizens are at their jobs doing whatever it is people do when the hero comes to town. Hark, what? And, like, some guy who's, like, following footpads on the ground, he's, like, that bunny guy, but now he's in, like, the giant bunny outfit and a suit, and has, like a rake with him. He's like, okay. And he's staying there, and the plugin guy walks up and kind of just pushes at him. He tries to push him over. Like, you can see the guy in the cage, like, hitting one bell over and over, and the dude keeps pushing him. No, the other one! The other one is talk! And he presses the other bell, and the mouth opens up and, like, screeching sounds come out. He's like, oh, I'm a simple farmer. Okay. This is the bunny guy. My village has been stolen of carrots. and the if I will give you treasure if you fix it. I will give you this thing in my hands, whatever it is, and you can use that on your quest, because you're obviously a hero of great renown. Screaming sounds coming from the wooden thing, like and then the mouth closes. I think he's trying to push him over. Ah! And until the guy pushes over, he just takes the rake and just hits him with it a few times.
Genocide run.
There's like, the hero got his first weapon without having to complete the boring quest. And, like, the dude in the cage looks actually pretty amused by this. This is pretty great.
That's your guy.
Yeah, that's your true face. He's like, oh, okay, all right, I'm getting the hang of this. He walks up to a bar. They're like, the bar shows up, and it says closed. And it's like, and then the hero went into the bar to get the rest of his traveling companions. And, like, the bar's closed. It looks like a single pane of wood with the word bar painted onto it and nothing else. And, like, he's, like, hitting against it and, like, hitting with the rake. He's trying to break through it until he breaks through, like, the entire wall and walks in. And there's nothing there.
But the bar didn't exist to begin with because of a problem with production.
Merger.
What?
Merger.
Merger?
The shop.
Shop bar. It looks like whoever was making this play was lazy and didn't fix this problem when they were testing it. Oh well.
And the dude walks out of the...
self-deprecating?
No, it's a bug in the game.
Oh.
So the dude walks out, and, like, the thing falls over and, like, is made of really a bunch of garbage.
Alright, so now what does the hero do? I guess he goes and fights stuff? You should go do that. That's fun. People love killing things.
And, like, the little wooden guy starts walking around with the rake, starts, like, knocking over vases and, like, finding money in them. Like, Russian rubles and German marks and stuff, and, like, children's teeth and nuggets of gold. Just currency from all over. And then he starts going around and, like, starts, like, hitting the cobblestone of the stage, breaking through the floorboards and pulling out treasure chests.
Oh, look! You found a secret developer's room! I'm the director, and I developed this thing, and I left treasure behind so I could always win this game.
And he's just dragging the chest behind him. Another arm comes out of his back to, like, hold the chest and, like, put stuff into. So he has, like, a couple arms coming out of his wooden back now, like, keeping stock of his gear. And, like, pushing it into the real hands whenever the guy in the cage calls it up, using the various pulleys and stuff. So first-person inventory would work. And then he starts coming towards you guys.
Back towards the furthest back of the stage.
The screaming, buzzing noises. It's, like, using its hands to push against parts of the wall, like it's looking for a Doom secret entrance.
Good day, kind hero! Are you here to save us from the carrot bandit? We have many wares on sale today. We have also merged with the bar, so you can also buy alcohol beverages from our bar wench.
It looks like this store has two types of items in its inventory for some reason.
He just kind of walks in past you, knocking shit off the counter and, like, hitting chandeliers above and knocking that over. Coins and, like, money from different parts of the world start falling out.
Cash register.
Yeah, like, it, like, takes that, picks it up over its head and throws it outside into, like, a fountain.
What a truly great hero you are.
So I take off my cat costume and fight it.
It seems that the cat was in truth a cat, and this is now a ballroom bar fight.
Alright, what do you do? It has a rake. It's like just swinging it absentmindedly around like this is Gary's mod.
Surgeon Simulator.
Surgeon Simulator style.
I'm going to try to punch its head off.
Do it! So you're just going to punch it really hard?
Yeah.
Alright, this thing is slow and lumbering and garbage. So you just punch in the face a bunch over and over.
Basically.
And like the head starts to crack a bit like a Rock and Sock'em robot.
Like, eventually I'll let my claws come out and try to just rip its head off.
Alright, so yeah, at the end you uppercut it and yeah, the head goes up on a bunch of gears and pulleys and like chandelier parts and crystals. And starts like moving around like you can't quite see anymore. And like you can see the guy in the cage pulling and moving stuff.
Like, did the hero have an extra life?
Oh no, it would appear that you couldn't overcome this challenge in the shop because it's a challenge from the bar several levels later. It looks like you lose by default. Wasn't that fun?
Like, it just kind of falls over and there's like oil and wine pouring out of its neck wound.
Like, got the head, and I look out at the audience, like, did I do it right?
Yeah, all the mannequin actors pick up the rag and put it next to their eye like they're crying, but that's the only motion they do. And then giant letters come down, lit up by the spotlight that say, "Game over." Everyone gets quiet.
So, I mean, it sounded like that happened really fast, but that took hours.
Like, every scene change where we went to different loading screens, the loading screens were really long. Where people were shuffling shit around and, like, different people were coming in.
So the director gets out of his little announcing area and walks up to the guy. It's like, ah? Pretty fun, right? Right? Everyone starts clapping. The mannequins, everyone, the band.
I just got a head, so I don't clap. Not really sure why people are clapping. Maybe they're clapping for me because I won.
That's clearly
probably because I won. So I hold the head up.
You're taunting the PC.
Which is your keeper.
This must be what he wanted! I did it!
She's gonna get the hose again.
The Russian guy's kind of leaning on the cage and looking thoughtfully at the screen that says game over. And so, like, duh. Duh. Producer? You quite possibly have committed the greatest form of entertainment I could think of. Yes. Yeah. But the way you do it is garbage, so I'm just going to steal the idea. You're fired. You're just like, well, you can't fire. This is my domain. I invented this. You can't take it. I'm going to take it. I have my other lords are going to come and take this, because you're terrible. But this is great.
Can we hear this?
Oh yeah, this is like, they're talking like you guys aren't here.
That's pretty cool, huh?
It'll be fine.
It's like, you can't fire me. I'm the producer. I'm the bard. I'm the playwright. You people won't even know about half this stuff if I didn't steal it from the mortals. Nope, we're going to steal this. That's what you did. So we're going to do that too.
They do this all the time.
You're definitely fired. And we definitely want this concept. You can give it to us or we could kill you for it. And he's like, this is outrageous. I'll burn down your world.
I'm going to, like, step to, like, the back of the book.
I'll unleash a maelstrom on your kind, such as which the likes of which has not been seen since the dawn of their industrial age.
One of the holes in the stage that the hero, in quotes,
the hero ascends out of. There's a bunch down there, all standing still.
They're like the holes that he broke in to get treasure. Are there holes in the stage still?
Yeah, there's like treasure boxes down there and stuff. And like there's people who are feeding the treasure up. Like you can see other changelings down there who are waving at you who like feed up the treasure he finds.
I'm gonna like go into one of those holes.
I'm gonna follow you.
I'm gonna like go to the side of the building and just kind of like
hold your knees and kind of rock back and forth.
Yeah, I'm going as far away from as possible.
What's wrong?
You can't take it. You can't take it.
Pull that head off my claws and hand it to you. I'm like, see, it's okay.
I don't want that.
You hear more yelling and people arguing back and forth. And he like put, like you see the director from like below the rafters put his coat on. It's like, oh, you'll hear about this. You'll all hear about this. I've wrote in plays about wars. You've played war. I wrote about them. I know more than you do. You can't stop me. I'm a creative type. He like walks to the emergency exit and like throws it open and just walks out into nothing.
I'm gonna go with him. I'm gonna be like, oh, the door's open.
You just skitter out?
Yeah.
Where are you going?
The door's open.
What's out there?
I don't know. I've never been out there.
Well, why are you gonna go out there then?
Because he's the producer.
Seems like good enough logic. So I'm gonna go with you!
Okay.
You escaped from the theater!
They also said they were gonna burn it off.
So you're walking outside the theater, you look behind you, and it's like a single door that has like fire escape written on it, and it's been thrown open, and it's just like a door frame. In the middle of a blizzard, and like there are walls around you that are like twisted, broken piece of concrete with rebar going through, and the rebar are basically like vines and thorns. Made of, like, you know, construction materials.
Oh. Do you have any part of the cat outfit left?
No, you told me to take it off.
Yes, but now it's winter.
The winter of your disco tech.
What did I have on under my cat outfit?
Clothes, you hope? Maybe nothing.
Was it hopefully a woolen coat and some galoshes?
The script didn't call for you to have clothes. They just called for you to take off the cat outfit.
You have to change costume.
Yeah, okay. So where do we get costumes from?
There are footprints in the snow. The director's footprints from his gaudy military-style boots. Like some asshole from the 2000s would buy to look cool.
Not out here. But the producer will know. The director will know.
Yeah, okay.
He's now the developer.
The developer. The developer.
He's a game dev.
But I think if we just go back inside, then...
There's no theater throughout the doorframe. Like, just an empty doorframe with an open door that says fire exit.
No, because they took it. They took it. They took...
Yeah, the doorframe kind of teeters a bit and falls over.
Run over to that door and try closing it and opening it and closing it and opening it.
Yeah, nothing.
And flip it over and try again.
When you open the door the last time, words in the ice, because under the snow is permanent ice and, like, concrete, has written, under new management in the ice.
Well, how do we get back inside?
We don't. They took it.
But
they
the hunters...
They said they were going to take it and they took it.
But the hunters are in there, and then they're going to wonder where I went. And they might need me.
Well, then you shouldn't have come outside.
But you said it was a good idea. This is your fault.
It is a good idea.
It's dark out.
The director.
It's dark out, but it's also light in the same way that snow creates reflections from ambient light to make like the dark look kind of lit up.
Like we should follow the developer.
What else are we gonna do?
Exactly. It's a good idea.
And then I mumble something about, was it in your script?
Maybe it was.
I don't know.
Maybe this was the secret dialogue.
This is the secret dialogue! Oh! Oh, this makes so much more sense now. This is fine. This is part of the play. Or the game.
What? This is the true pacifist ending?
This is part of the game. We'll follow the developer, and then when the next scene starts, we'll start with it.
Uh-huh.
And then we'll get a costume change.
Uh-huh.
And then we'll get our new roles and our new lines, if there's lines this time.
Uh-huh.
And then it'll go back to normal.
Yeah.
Hopefully no snow next time. My feet are cool.
Yeah.
The shop girl was not a shop girl for an outside shop. It's metal. I don't know why. Hopefully my apron.
And then I shrug and I just start running in the direction of the footprints. Full war.
Gonna go after her.
You guys start following the footprints in the snowscape in the concrete jungle. So there's no real way to know how much time passes, but time goes by. It seems like it's taking forever. A lot of stuff seems familiar, though. Stuff you haven't really seen in a while. Like, you see, like, hints of buildings behind the rebar and whatnot. You remember something about this. Oh, shit, I was gonna use that if you weren't from 2015. Shit, I forgot. My bad. But yeah. You remember things from, like a place where there were books that you'd have to read or watch things or do stuff. You remember seeing pictures of this? Like, you're going along a wall and it has like a guard station and like there's like a sledgehammer at the bottom and a bunch of the walls been torn down. And like you can see like signs of people have spray painted it or they're gonna party here. And it's just like this huge chunk of wall among the vines and the rebar thorns.
1988.
Tear down this wall. You hear, actually, yeah, there's like an old klaxon you can hear just vaguely cracking through someone saying, tear down this wall.
Oh! Is that our next line? I'll pick up the sledgehammer if I can. Can I pick it up?
You'll start tearing down the wall.
This is the next line.
There's one for you, too.
This is the next line.
I'm just
You'll probably
watch her
be
now.
Better at this than I am. I'm generally the shop girl. You seem to be the bar wench and fighter.
So you want me to tear down a wall?
That's what the line said.
Well, he didn't go through a wall, though, and we're going after... What was this?
The footprints do stop at the wall.
They... Oh.
The lines say to tear down the wall. It says, tear down this wall!
Alright. Pick up the sledgehammer. Because you're handing it to me. And I'm gonna tear down the wall.
Okay, you punch a hole through this thing after a couple swings. It goes much easier than you expect something of this quality to do. Like, it's almost fake or something. Or, but yeah, like, sledgehammer, rock, hammer.
Everything is fake.
Rock beats paper, and you take down the wall. Yeah, there's a hole that leads through it. It looks like the vaguest outline, like it's been a background set made out of plywood that is like a city skyline, and like there've been holes cut for windows, and there's like candles in there off in the distance lighting it up. There's still a snowstorm going through. And yeah, there are footprints on the other side of the wall.
Excellent. If we just follow the lines, we just have to follow the lines.
You mean the footprints?
Physically follow the footprints. Verbally and emotionally follow the lines.
Alright, if you say so.
Alright, crawling through the hole you guys made, because it's not quite big enough for you guys. You know, you only get like a kind of hole and it's fairly thick. Crawling through, you can feel the rebar scraping against you and clawing into you. And as you like move over, like grab some of the bars and to pull yourself through, it feels like your hand slips on something and like you wrench something loose, and it just like stabs itself with your hand and burrows in. Ah. Same thing happens to you. Ah. You feel different.
What is this? What's going on?
Oh man, do you remember your name from before you were abducted by monsters? Oh, that just comes back.
Which is far more pressing than, ow, my hand.
Same with you.
Oh?
Oh, shit, you're on a playground. You had mommies.
I had more than one mommy.
Something took you. Some dude with a neckbeard took you.
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
Worst case scenario.
He put you in a burlap sack, threw over his back, and took you to the playhouse.
Oh. Okay.
Oh.
You swung the sack around a bit so you'd stop crying. And then...
Casting call?
Yes, casting call. That's what the bag said.
Okay. I don't know what I'm going to do.
Are we through at this point? Or are we
yes,
still...
you go through the thorns to get your souls back.
Okay.
Which is literally what happens when you leave the hedge.
That's fucked.
I'm going to just lay in the snow and stare up for a couple minutes while, you know...
There are low... You can sort of see them in the soft light of the midnight snowstorm, but there are low-hanging light bulbs hanging from the ceiling on, like, basically barbed wire lines swinging softly in the wind. For stars.
Do you know where this is?
It looks like it's the outside set.
I don't think we're on a set anymore.
The developer always said life is but a stage. All the world's a stage, some shit like that.
The director always says that life is but a stage.
Yeah, I don't think this is one,
but
though.
Those aren't stars. They're supposed to be stars, but they're not stars. So it's the outdoor set.
But we left.
But we didn't leave.
But... just shake my head and get up.
This is how it works sometimes. Sometimes the playhouse is just like one book, and sometimes it's a...
I used to hang out with other kids. And like eat cookies and watch TV shows. Hey, you remember what TV is? That was great.
Oh, that was kind of like that.
You're really excited to go see a movie about a kid's show that you watched.
Cars 2 was coming out.
No. That was 2015. Cars 2 is already come and gone. This would be like one of the My Little Pony movies, the ones where they're people. Or what's another kid's movie that just came out?
The Friendly Dinosaur?
Oh my god, yeah, that just came out, didn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Another dinosaur movie.
Or was it the nice dinosaur? The good dinosaur?
Some shit.
The Pixar.
It was good.
There have been 80 kid dinosaur movies. Remember Littlefoot?
What if this car
remember when his mom thing? Died?
What if fish have feelings?
What if feelings have feelings?
That's exactly what that was, which
exactly.
Is amazing. Okay. Okay.
What do you guys do?
Is there a footprint still?
Yep.
I guess. Are there paths in here?
No, just one corridor, basically. Like, there's other paths, but they're not the ones the footprints go down.
I'm not following the footprints anymore. I'm just going to grab your arm and start dragging you off on the other ways.
Oh, careful, that will come out.
Won't drag quite as hard.
Okay, you leave the trail that the developer left behind and go your own way. After a while, the concrete and rebar and steel leavings and, like, shale left behind by the buildings gives way to, like, walls that have, like, vines growing through them and being torn up by, like, hanging moss and stuff. And eventually that gives way to an actual hedge bush in summer at night, on, like, just a cool, windy autumn night. I said summer, but I meant autumn.
Well, at least it's not snowing. Vernon Preston Garvey quote. That's what he always says.
Preston Garvey. Oh, the NPCs are so repetitive. In the raining, actually. Living in the Mojave makes you wish for a nuclear winter. That's what they said in New Vegas.
Thank you. I can finally think straight again.
Ever since we talked, I'm feeling swell. Look at us, here in Sanctuary, prepared for the future. Every fucking time. Fuck. Fuck you, Marcy Long. Okay, yeah, so you're in, like, an autumn leaf-filled thorn maze.
Gonna just start wandering, still holding on to your arm, unless you stop me.
I'm not gonna stop you. But I'm kind of looking back at the footprints being like,
oh. Oh, there are no footprints back there. Now it looks like exactly the same whichever way you look.
I was going to start freaking out, but that happens sometimes.
I don't ever get lost. I always know which way is a certain way.
Even in the hedge?
I don't know about the hedge.
The hedge. Yeah. That'd be a really cheap power to defeat that hedge.
But I do have that.
Yeah.
So, just, you know.
Yeah, it's the prelude. You're not going to get lost and die in character creation.
That would be amazing.
I've had...
your characters.
What are you, George R. Martin?
There's your change.
The Traveler RPG system literally does that. You can die in character creation. Because it's all random tables.
Wow.
Yeah. After a while of walking, you find a part of the hedge that's kind of depressed in the side and has a metal and steel frame and sliding doors and elevator buttons on the side.
Going up.
Yeah, you hear a ding, and the doors slide open.
Just an elevator?
Yeah.
And, like, my kitty ears perk up when the ding happens. Kind of look around, like, and then I kind of smush back down again, like, oh.
You go on the elevator?
Yeah.
Okay, there's someone in the elevator.
Who is it?
So... Mr. Wisp! You've been tracking down a missing persons case.
Alright.
There have been a rash of them in the city in Canada that's a big city that has a lot of snow. That is the setting that you live in. It's not Toronto, it's not Calgary, it's just the big snow city here in Canada.
Okay.
In, I don't know, Alberta or some shit.
Really shitty place. Gotcha.
There have been a rash of disappearances. Like, really sloppy kidnappings. Like, no cover, no letter, anything. They just disappear. Mm-hmm. There's an old abandoned building that you know about that for some reason is on the radar for where strange stuff goes down. Like, there's blog postings and actual old BBS postings about it dating back to, like, the 80s. Mm-hmm. It used to be a pharmaceutical company by the name of Pentex that worked out of there. And they were since folded in with the Department of Defense. They were a pharmaceutical company that the American Department of Defense was able to buy and close down their foreign offices. So it's just been empty, but it's still technically owned by the Canadian government, working with the American government's Department of Defense. So it just stands there being not maintained and being not owned and having military security around sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
You have snuck in. You've been looking around. There have been various... graffiti and signs that aren't the most promising around here, talking about weird stuff like lights at night, or things in the sky, or bug-eyed people taking children by the hand. Weird shit.
Clear alien abduction case.
Yeah. The elevators still run. There's no power in any other part of the building, but you approach one of the elevators, it's lit up, and it's like doors are opening. Like, when you get to it, the doors are open, and they're starting to close, and it's lit up.
Alright, I jam a hand into,
Alright, you slink your way into the elevator as it closes, and you hear a voice, like a simple childlike voice, go, "Going up!" And the elevator starts going up.
Oh.
Okay. Then it stops, and, you get the smell of autumn and pumpkin spice lattes as the door opens and you get a gust of air as these two assholes are there getting into the elevator.
Oh, teenage white girls, that's a shock.
Pumpkin spice.
I knew it was coming.
So you have the shopkeeper clothes that are made of metal and you're wearing nothing.
But that doesn't really seem to bother me.
It doesn't seem to bother you, but I just want to set the scene here.
Alright.
You guys also have like cuts all over you from the hedge maze. And, like, all your hair and your clothes that you have are all ruffled, and there's, like, bits of thorn and some flowers stuck on you. Like, I gotta pull out these burrs.
So, I'm still holding her arm.
We just look like people, right?
Yeah. Well, are we in the hedge right now?
Not when you get in the elevator.
Okay. So, if we're in the elevator, then I don't think our mean would be showing. I think our
mask everyone looks normal to everyone else.
Yeah, so, like, even when I look like a human, this is what I look like. That's a real person, by the way.
I thought so. What the
fuck?
Okay.
Still
fairly creepy.
So yeah, they're just there in a room, or?
You see something beyond the threshold of them walking in, but it's blurry and kind of hurts to look at.
When you say something, does it mean, you mean like a person?
Or like a place. There's like a place just beyond them, but it actually hurts to kind of look into.
I kind of moved to the side of you.
Like, like the feeling of staring at, like, really blinding strobe static too long.
Oh. Okay. Shit, get in here. What the hell are you doing? Why are you naked? What's going on here?
What are you talking about?
You're naked. And so? Also in the basement of a military facility building.
No, we ain't.
Come on.
The door shuts behind them, the elevator starts moving again, and it just stops and opens halfway.
Oh.
It's another floor of the building. Just okay. A floor, an empty floor, an empty office space.
I'm gonna draw my revolver. Kind of pull out defensively as I kind
I'm gonna draw out my gun.
You're just your hand, like a
just my hand!
I'm going to scowl at you and your revolver.
Who brought you here?
She brought me here.
Technically, she kind of brought me here.
How old did you look again?
25.
25-ish.
Yeah. Okay. I guess I should probably describe my character.
Oh, I was gonna.
What does Mr. Wisp look like?
It's kind of hairy, heavy sideburns, kind of shaggy hair. He wears a very classic noir detective kind of outfit, like the trench coat and the trilby. No, fedora, rather. Trilby's the other one. But, yeah, and he kind of has vaguely sharp-looking canines and kind of pointed ears, almost. A touch inhuman.
Okay.
Yellow eyes.
That's more than a touch.
Yeah. And
I think he's
got
to see a doctor.
Yeah. And he's got kind of this bracelet, so a couple bracelets around his wrist that are like made from animal teeth. But yeah.
You're a hunter.
Okay, just stay behind me. I'll get you out of here. And we can figure out what's going on after we're out of here.
Are you the hero?
Yeah, let's go with that.
Okay, we are princesses, and you're saving us from the tower. That's what's happening. I'll holster my gun.
I don't think this is a play. And my character, like...
It's not a play. It's an interactive entertainment.
Yeah, I'm going to say that. It's not a play. It's an interactive entertainment.
Experience.
Yeah, this is an experience, all right. Come on.
None of my characters out of the hedge. Too. All those hieroglyphic tattoos, they all look like really generic, like in the tattoo parlor kind of tattoos, like anchors and stuff like that.
Oh, right, he's gonna take off his trench coat and like, kind of hang it over your shoulders.
I'm just gonna let it fall back on the ground again.
Kind of does up the button, the top button.
He's gonna frown at it.
I'm gonna start braiding your hair.
Yeah, rescue or not, I can't be seen with like naked,
like, swat your hand away, like...
No, you're the princess.
I thought you were the princess.
We're both princesses.
He's there can't be two both. Princesses. That's not even how it works.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah, it is. The daddy king has two princesses. Usually one turns evil.
Who's the king?
I call not being the evil one. I'm the good princess. But you still have to be pretty, so I'm gonna braid your hair like a princess.
I'm just gonna shove you away from me.
See? I told you I was the good princess.
Just step out of the elevator.
Hey, where are you going?
Come with me. I'm getting you out of here.
So where?
I'm gonna follow.
Somewhere safe.
Do you know where the hunt is off?
The what?
The hunter.
He looks to be a hunter. He's probably be a hunter hero. He has teeth and a gun, and he has... the rest of him doesn't look much like a hunter, but he has a gun, and he has, like, teeth bracelets. So he probably killed a lot of bad guys.
Do I know the name of the... Like, am I following a specific missing person case, or just a,
Yeah, it's like a specific missing person case, but it's like an old man.
Oh, an old man went missing?
Yeah.
Okay.
We didn't do it.
Alright. So yeah, I'm not gonna bring that up just yet. I'll just kind of try to usher them out of here.
Do things seem really weirdly normal right now?
Super weirdly normal.
Like, things are so normal, it's weird.
Yeah. Like, time's passing, you realize you're probably hungry at this point. There's no break for food like there usually is.
My stomach's like... Wah, 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 wah.
So, what's on this floor?
Empty office space, like desks, some empty filing cabinets. Yeah.
These sets are really well done.
I'm gonna, like, stick my head out of the elevator following and kind of, like, peek around with just my head first.
I'm gonna, like, pick up something. What's around?
A typewriter.
I'm gonna, like, pick up a typewriter and be like, oh, wow. Kind of click at it.
Is there a window nearby?
Or? Oh yeah, plenty of windows. It's an office building.
What floor are we on?
Like the fourth floor.
Better use the staircase. Come on.
I'm gonna, like, make motions of, like, walking downstairs, like, behind one of the desks. Are you? It didn't work. I am downstairs now.
You try your best to make the scene swipe, but it's not happening.
The stairs didn't work, so we'll go down the other stairs, the back entrance.
The real stairs? I kind of point to the, you know, emergency
The door marked stairs?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Those stairs will work this time. Right, kind hero?
Yeah.
Now I'm going to start walking way too close to you, like, brushing shoulders as we go towards the stairs.
Okay. Yeah, I better not be caught with this, or...
Well, at least we're not underage.
Yeah, it's still two beat-up young women.
True.
In an abandoned building.
And they seem like they might be a little...
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm going to take them down the stairs, the stairwell.
I'll, like, lower my voice. Be like, you ain't really, like, a king or a hero or something, right? Like, she's wrong, right?
I'm not a hero.
Are you a king?
No.
Are you an actor?
No.
Are you in a game?
No.
Are you in a play?
No.
Do you know who the... Hey, what's that guy's name?
Which guy?
The guy that does the stuff with you guys.
The director? The keeper? The producer?
That one.
The developer. He's the developer now.
There's a developer? What was he doing to you?
Oh, he made all sorts of new things. I'm usually the shop girl. She was the barmaid, and she got in a fight. She had to take off her cat suit and reveal that she was a cat.
What?
It was about the duality of books and how sometimes books are just the same as their cover.
Just shaking my head.
Just gonna pull a cigarette out and just...
Oh, and also cats!
Like that.
I'm gonna get really close to your cigarette. Like,
what are you doing?
You want one?
Oh? Mine! Not mine, but mine! That's really... They don't usually actually go down when you do it.
Bat it out of your hand.
Roy!
And then I'm going to pick it up off the floor, because it's mine now.
Because it's on the floor.
Right, well,
Oh my god. You fucking kids.
I'm going to lead them down the stairs. Ahead of me.
I'm not going to go ahead
of you. Just in case she starts to, like, bat other things.
I'm going
to
try to walk down the stairs directly beside you. No matter how many times you step backwards.
What, between his legs?
No, I'm just gonna keep shifting with you back and forth.
Okay. I'm gonna get them out of here.
I'm gonna try to, like, walk like a princess.
Shake my head at you again.
I'm gonna assume I have, like, a beat up old car or something outside.
Oh, yeah.
So. When they're dressed in his beat up.
It's a really shitty car.
Yeah, it's like a 2012 Hummer. The only car you could afford, the one nobody wanted anymore.
It has, like, a pizza sticker on the side that's been scraped away as best it can be, but...
This is definitely a Humvee.
It just says the.
Yeah. Za.
Two lanes wide.
The hero of Za.
Alright, so assuming I can just sneak past security...
There's no security here right now.
Yeah, okay. Okay, get in the back of the car.
I want to go in the front.
Okay.
You know what, you crawl over the seat to the back and then the front again?
Yeah, no, just sit in the front. Just
into the trunk.
Only dreams now.
I get into the car and sit in, like, the middle seat.
You're in a large city.
And now we're in the car and we're driving to our destination. Can I blink my eyes like I'm expecting it to reset? Okay.
Start the car?
This is elaborate as fuck.
Oh, that seems like a waste of time.
That's terrible pacing.
That's terrible pacing.
So where are we going?
So you're in a giant city, like, just skyscrapers everywhere, really metropolitan downtown area, snow.
Slush.
Well, it's not slushy yet because it's still, like, really thick snow cover coming down. It's like a heavy middle of winter storms. It's all white, crisp snow at this point. Like, it's being, like, packed down by cars going back and forth, but none of that shit's melting.
Do we drive by a park?
No, not in this area of town.
I should probably drive them to a hospital. I assume that's... They're looking pretty beat up, and also, you know...
They came out of a weird place that fucked with your eyes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that doesn't happen.
Yeah, so...
Something's afoot.
Something's clearly
afoot. You are a gumshoe.
That is true. Yeah, I'll just take them to my office.
That's normal?
I have medical kit.
Okay, so you drive down the street for a while, you know, coasting along the ice to slide to save gas.
Mm-hmm.
Precious, precious gas.
Really, really far forward in the seat, of course, and look out the front window.
I can't afford another ticket.
You can't afford to refill the tank on this piece of shit.
No.
Ooh, this episode's sponsored by Humvees. And eventually you pull up to the bowling alley that is now a dance recital place that your apartment is over.
Okay. Office.
Kind of just open the doors to both. Kind of. Here.
Oh, yeah. Come on. Is my outfit still made of metal? Like, I'm still wearing, like, a metal...
It looks a little bit more like it's, like, crappy, shiny aluminum.
Weird. Okay. Like, they're kind of, like...
Like a rain poncho.
Like the kind of, like, future material that clothes are made out of in crappy sci-fi?
Yeah. Okay. Like, it looks like a rain poncho that's made of, like, really, really bad Legion aluminum.
Weird. Okay.
When I get out of the car, the coat flaps over my shoulders, and then I have to pull it back around myself.
Jesus.
But I'm like, oh yeah, it's cold. This sucks.
This is garbage.
Yeah,
yeah, there's a side. There's, like, a fire escape ladder on the outside you have to walk up and, like, have to unlock the gate for... With, like, the key you have, or, like, just wrench the lock open, then you have to go up to, like, your side apartment.
Mm-hmm.
The dance studio lets you use one of the bowling alley change rooms as an office.
It's really good that we ran across someone who happened to have not been evil or something. Like, we're just two random, like, chicks that are really out of it. It's just like, they want to use naked? Okay, well, you're coming back to my place. And we're like, okay!
John Mulaney.
Don't worry, I'm not gonna rape you. I'm a little boy.
You need to listen to John Mulaney's stand-up, Gayle. It's amazing.
Anyway, yeah, I kind of usher them in.
Alright, describe your shitty apartment while I get another cupcake.
It's got one of those pull-out couches that he uses as a bed slash computer chair for a shitty old, like, Windows 95 computer. Let's see. Instead of a stove, he has a hot... Or what are those called? Those hot tables? Or
a hot plate?
Hot plate, yeah. He has one of those. There's something kind of semi-boiling over. It's been simmering all day.
And not be used as slow cookers.
Yeah. Because this thing, place doesn't have hydro, he has like a one of those old water coolers with the big jugs. It's really bare
Americans,
bones.
Most Americans don't know what hydro is, and you try to explain it, they're like, is that in water?
What is hydro?
Hydro's power comes from hydroelectric dams here in Canada.
There we go. I was like, why is your electricity called hydro? That makes no sense.
Yeah.
I never thought about it before.
Yeah, he's
got
like...
That's how most Americans respond, actually.
Yeah, he's got like a generator outside of one of the windows on a balcony that's kind of chugging away. Yeah. Water, he just uses the water cooler. There's like a shower downstairs in one of the changing rooms that, you know, he can slip into when the place is closed. He's not supposed to, but... Yeah, and kind of littered everywhere, like in desks and behind glass, are just animal bones. Just bits and pieces everywhere.
I'm gonna pick up an animal bone and just kind of like look at it.
I'm gonna like
look. Not accusingly, just curiously.
I'm gonna like look out all the windows, like I'm looking for something.
And a lot of the walls are pasted with like newspaper clippings from various cases, or just really mundane shit, even like parades and, you know, opening sales and stuff like that. And there's kind of yarn everywhere connecting all of them with pins.
Careful! You have a cat in your apartment now!
So you have the serial killer wall set up?
Yeah. Basically. A lot of stuff is like from like daily news and stuff like that, like really.
Weekly World News?
Yeah, like alien abduction, the werewolf shit, and, you know, vampire boy spotted again.
Mm. Yeah, news clipping on the wall. Bat boy hits Caitlyn Jenner in head-on collision. That's a new article.
And there's like a ton of yarn attached to that one from various other cases.
Devin, please get me milk. Please get me milk.
Fresh from the cow. Go get a cow.
These cupcakes are fucking amazing.
This episode also brought to you by Cupcakes.
Frosting's Cupcakery.
In Langley, BC.
This has way too much icing.
Chunks of...
No way!
If you don't go to Frosting's Cupcakery in Langley, BC, you're a piece of shit. Right. Advertising for me.
Yeah, also, the place is kind of chilly, but there's one of those space heaters just on that he immediately turns on when he walks in.
Man, that's ghetto.
This is new.
Yeah.
Loud. Very loud.
Kind of sits on the edge of the bed and reaches over to where the hot plate is. He just kind of starts spooning out, like, it looks like gruel, basically. Like, rice mixed with, like, possibly frozen veggies. And stuff like that. And it's been on the heater so long, it's just basically, like, gray mush.
That looks really good.
Is this food break time?
Yeah, here.
Casting table?
Pulls out a pair of bowls and just kind of... He's got, like, bowls, and he kind of, like, wipes it out with the back of his hand. He's like, Yeah, he pours, like, a third of it in each bowl and slides it over. It's like, you look hungry.
Yes.
Hungry for blood!
Yeah, just, Frank, he pulls out, like, these there's a bunch of plastic spoons in a drawer. Like, the ones that are still in the wrap.
My character is already eating it with her face.
Yeah, I was, like, tilting it and trying to drink it.
Weren't you just putting it at your face and acting like you should be full by it? Like,
yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, exactly. I was doing that. I was just like, this is really good.
Just pantomime slamming it against your face.
There's no more. There's none missing from the bowl. I just kept saying that it was good. And I'll put it down. And I'll be like, I'm so hungry.
There's a knock at your door.
Shit.
Like, just a banging. Hey! Hey!
Stay low.
Fred!
Just is that the
stay quiet.
Try to speak up more when you're whispering, guys.
Stay quiet.
What if we stay quiet?
Oh, wait, yes.
How will this? How will the audience hear us?
Yeah, this isn't your part yet. You've got to stay quiet.
Oh, I'll like get all
so
like.
So now it is a play.
I'll like sit up and like my arms will go like stiff, like I'm like waiting, and I'll like kind of just tilt my head, just like.
Yeah, he goes to the door and he kind of presses his shoulder against it so it can't be pulled open, and he just kind of cracks
it's your
it
landlord.
And I'm like, is it a play or not?
It's your landlord, Mrs. Earring, like E-R-W-I-N-G, like Earring. She's old and doesn't care and calls you Fred or Frank or Frisbee. FR is really what she gets right. Frank! Frank!
Yeah, it's me.
My Netflix doesn't work, Frank!
Oh, your Netflix? Did you try, is the cord plugged
in? I didn't try fucking shit. You're gonna fix it, Frank. Oh, you live above my dance studio? You shower in my changing room? You shit in my toilet? You're gonna fix my Netflix.
Well, you told me to get rid of the bucket.
You're gonna fix my Netflix, Frank.
Yeah, I can do that.
You're gonna go to the store later and get me a pack of smokes and a quart of rum. I got back from the hospital. They put me on dialysis. They said I shouldn't drink beer no more, so I'm going to drink rum.
I'm going to come over to the door and stick my face right down around knee height into the crack.
Oh, hey, this is...
Here, fix my Netflix!
Right, all right.
And she just walks away.
Is it my part yet?
And then she just walks away, smoking.
She smells terrible.
Oh, no, she thinks I have two hookers in here.
No, I'm the shop girl.
She's supposed to be the barmaid.
Yeah, she's the barmaid.
Yeah, she thinks I'm into some really
I thought we were
shit.
Princesses.
We were, but he's not a hero. He seems to be a hunter? Or something.
Why can't the hero be a hunter?
He could. Little Red Riding Hood had a hunter as the hero.
No, it was a woodsman.
Look, I gotta go
What's
fix this whole base.
What's the difference between a woodsman and a hunter?
A woodsman hunts wood, and a hunter hunts things that need hunting.
A woodsman hunts wood.
He kind of knocks down in the wood.
He what?
Kind of, or, like, he makes it sound like,
we're going to the bald, I'm a woodman.
Jesus Christ.
We're like, going to the bald.
The sound
directors
make when they have the clappers.
The clappers?
What are they talking to me that's happening right now?
Yeah,
Nicole's
going to
choke on her cupcake.
Please don't.
And then she died.
Yeah, he kind of makes that sound. He's like, all right, I gotta go fix the old bag's, you know, Netflix so she can watch Angel.
She didn't look like a bag.
So, you two just stay up here, stay warm.
I want to come with you.
What's a Netflix?
It's... How long were you down in that basement?
I don't know.
There wasn't a basement. Usually it's a shop.
Shop.
Usually it's a shop. Sometimes it's other things, but usually. I'm very good at playing the shop girl.
Right, well, you know what? You can come if you want.
Yay!
You know, don't get into anything. If I touch anything in that apartment other than her TV, she's gonna... the whole thing with the police again.
So are you now bringing your location hookers with you? to fix the Netflix? Is that...
Apparently, yes.
Just curious, am I staying
you're
in the
naked.
Coat or
oh,
do you
shit.
Have
I forgot
do you
you're
have,
naked.
Am I staying in the coat or are you gonna give me some clothes here? Just
right. He starts fishing through his one dresser drawer
okay.
and starts pulling out like they're his outfits.
How
obviously.
Tall is your character?
He's like 6.5 feet.
Okay, that's good. My
I thought you were a giant.
So
oh, a giant.
She's 6 foot, so
pretty giant.
Just wanted to check.
That's very much not a giant. I could pass for really any age. You probably don't know how old I am, actually, now I'm thinking about it. I'm like 5 feet tall and too skinny.
Yeah.
Like, she looks like she needs sandwich.
Yeah, so he's got, like, very detective-y outfits, like button-up shirts and slacks, and he's like, here, I don't really have anything for women here.
I'm just gonna, like, hold on to them for a second.
Costume change.
What, they're not good enough? Do you need, like, a pretty dress?
Costume change.
I mean, I guess they have the dance studio downstairs.
Roll my eyes and change into them.
Do you have any not metal outfits? Costumes?
Do you want to...
This one isn't great. It hurts. It's sharp. My costume's pointy. That's fine if I'm playing the shop girl from the play, the interactive entertainment experience, but... I don't seem to be in that role anymore, and this is very sharp.
I'm gonna take a look at that apron. Is it just literally metal, or...?
It's like really shitty aluminum.
Jesus.
Aluminum foil dress.
Gonna tear that off you? Like, what the hell?
Oh!
So
So the aliens can't read plays. Your butt thoughts.
Why are you two so pretty?
He kind of pulls out another one of those shirts. This one's kind of stained with coffee and vomit.
Do you want the coat?
Don't worry, it's not like... mine.
That doesn't make it better! Anyways, what?
You want the coat?
I'll wear the coat. I'll be a detective.
Right, yeah.
I'll button it up. It's gonna be way too big on her, though. This is stupid.
Let's drag it on the floor.
This is stupid.
Right, I guess I'm gonna take them down to the,
You hear someone banging on the floor below you.
That's fine.
I'm gonna jump up and down.
Don't worry, babe! Oh, we're coming to Flix your Netflix!
I'm coming to Flix your Netflix!
I also called her Bag, by the way. I said, don't worry, Bag. We're coming to Flix your Netflix.
I'm gonna continue jumping up and down all the way to the door. Boing, 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 boing.
Oh, God, this is a nightmare.
Thought we were playing a game. You bang, I bang.
Nobody's so you go downstairs to the bowling alley. There's, like, the administrative office. She turned to, like, a little loft for herself.
Mm-hmm.
Like, one of the bowling lanes still works when people, like, they've ripped out, like, the dividers from the bowling lanes and put down more hardwood, but one of the lanes is still there so she can still bowl at the ripe old age of 79.
Jesus. Good for her. Good for her.
I'm the strikeout gal! I once kicked some, and she says a racial slur, in the face with a bowling ball!
It's very nice. I've told the story so many times.
He was fresh off the potato boat!
The slur she used did not line up with that stereotype.
Okay, you keep, Miss... What's her name again?
Irwin.
Hold back.
You keep Miss Irwin company, and I'll just be a sec here.
No, I want to go with you.
Hi, Irwin.
It's in the same room.
Hey, kid.
I follow you.
Are okay. you... What's... I'm the detective now. And I'll pretend to pull up my gun.
Kids in your filthy role plays.
I pretend to pull up my gun, and I'm like, I'm the detective now. And I'll make like a detective pose.
Ah, that's sweet. My granddaughter's got a friend who's retarded like you. Aren't you the sweetest thing?
Huh?
Tell me, are you the type of detective that pays his fucking rent on time?
I haven't got my lines yet. That sounds like a deep blow, by the way.
Yeah.
You're getting, like, retarded pokers high on blow.
Wow.
This is all he could afford.
So, you know what the problem with her Netflix was?
What?
She didn't open the website.
Jesus Christ, this woman.
Wait, what?
She didn't open the Netflix website on her TV, like, on the computer. She was just like, you open Netflix and it works.
Miss Irving, I wrote all the instructions down for you. Where did the instructions...
If I wanted to read instructions, I'd take them, knock you out with a bowling ball, and have them tattooed on your scrotum, so the next time you go blow yourself, you know how to fix my Netflix for me, you white trash piece of shit.
Oh my, such colorful dialogue.
That only happened once.
Now fix the Netflix. Is it fixed?
Fix the remote.
Yeah, there you go.
There, it's fixed.
Yeah. Here, take the fucking instructions with you. I'm done blowing my nose with them. Yeah, that's right. Walk away.
Back up to the office.
Goodbye, Big!
Yeah, see you later, sweetie.
She rattles through her cupboard and gets you one of those little strawberry candies old people have.
Oh, thank you!
Now, there you go.
I'll be like this.
Yeah, that's sweet.
Yeah, they're too hard for her tea, so she just suckles on the first layer. Not for Melanie.
You guys go back upstairs to the apartment.
Which is difficult, because you've got a 6-foot tall woman who's trying to walk on your ankles.
It's not working.
What do you mean it's not working?
Oh!
She's just touching the candy wrapped in its foil to her lips. It's not, nothing's happening.
He unwraps it. It's like, put it in your mouth and let it melt.
Oh.
Don't choke on it, for the love of God.
Oh my!
You remember eating now?
This is good.
That was a thing you used to do.
What is this?
It's candy. It's old person
candy. We need more candy. We need more old people candy.
Kind of sits back down on the bed. He's like, just got a, with one hand, he opens up, like, a website of missing, like, a missing persons registry, and he's trying to line you, your faces up with, like...
You've been gone for about 10 years, but you were, like, a 15-year-old? Yeah. So you probably look kind of the same, right? Like, how much do you change? Like, how much does your mask change?
Not that much.
Yeah, like, you still probably look generally like yourself.
Yeah. Except for all the tattoos.
All the tattoos.
All on my person. Like, all the way up my neck to the base of my chin.
Yeah, and it's been 10 years. You're, like, 15 now. You're now. Yeah. And also, she was, you know, probably different complete style.
She probably
also,
had, like, long hair when she was younger. Like, she's got, like, a can I speak to the manager haircut like? Now?
Okay. Also, she might not even... Were you even... Do you have a fetch? Like... You might not even been reported missing.
Yeah, she probably had a fetch.
No. Yeah, you're not even missing.
I wouldn't be missing either. Especially because it was only 2 days ago when I was 6 years old.
Oh.
So yeah, you're looking up missing people, then. Nope.
Did you have a fetch?
Yeah.
Okay. Then yeah, you guys aren't missing.
Okay, describe to me what happened. Like, you're cut up, you're naked, you're...
I'm not naked, you give me clothes.
You were like naked.
They don't feel me very good.
What happened was, there was an interactive entertainment experience, and the hunters were going to take it from the producer.
But I won.
Developer. They're going to take it from the developer because she won and they liked it. So, we followed the developer out of the theater,
and
into the snow.
But it wasn't here.
No, we followed them out of the theater into the snow, and then we broke down a wall, and then we were in, somewhere, and then there was the elevator, and we got in the elevator, and you're like, who are you? You're naked and blah, blah, blah. You're all cut up and stuff. And then we pulled out our guns and then we went up the elevator and then we went into your car and then we went to your this set. I went to the bag set and then we went to this set again.
Uh-huh.
And there was candy. There was old people candy. There's old people candy.
Yes, I was there for that part.
What do you ask?
Kind of gets up and walks over. There's like a glass of like half-drinking whiskey in the corner. He fills the other half up with water. Starts setting that down. So, you think this is part of a play?
Well, it usually is. But this is different. It's very, very, it goes to 1, 2, 3. Usually it goes, like, from 1 to zebra. Then, like, to 3. And there was not so much...
Filler? Did they feed you anything? Inject you with anything?
We always had cast table with all the cast food for everybody.
You guys do understand that you hang out with fairies, though. You know they're fairies. That's a thing you definitely know.
That's why I kept saying she's not here. We're not... Not. Yeah. It didn't happen here. Sorry.
Okay.
Just throwing that out there, you comprehend that you were hanging out with fairies.
Do you have any furniture?
The bed is a fold-up couch.
The bed is a fold-up couch? Is it unfolded?
Yes.
I'm going to go over to it and just sprawl while she's talking.
Yeah. He's sitting on it, like, trying to... use the missing persons.
Yeah, and there was the table, and no, I was usually the shop girl, so there was no injecting or anything like that. I was always just the shop girl. But before that, there was the casting call, and there was like a playground, and then the director came, and it was casting call. And then he brought me to the theater, and then we were in the theater.
As far as I'm understanding from this, it's basically some girl went in for a casting call, got kidnapped, and tortured. Until she was so blitzed out of her mind that she can't, like, differentiate between, what about you?
Did you believe what she said?
I think that's what she believes happened.
But did you believe what she said?
It doesn't seem like she's lying.
Alright, Oh, the hunters came! She's from the hunters.
Yeah.
The hunters, what are they?
They hunt stuff. But they don't anymore. Now they play games, I guess.
They stole it!
What sort of games?
The kind of games with a guy that walks around and wrecks stuff and gets things. Mostly.
He was the brave hero.
Did he hit you? Is that why?
Oh, he didn't get attacked. She won. She won the play.
I ripped his head off.
Yeah.
So you ripped the head off this hunter that had you both.
But he wasn't real.
But he wasn't
real. No, the hunter was actually over there, and he was telling the hero what to do with all the crates.
The hunter was playing him.
Yeah.
He started to type stuff down. Just
what are you doing?
Taking case notes.
That's rude.
This is required. Keep talking.
Is it on a laptop?
No, it's like a heavy old computer.
I'm gonna get up and knock off desk.
Old computer.
Crash! Yeah. Well, that's never gonna be replaced.
I'm sorry.
Now it's going.
No, you're not.
This didn't break through the floor again.
I look at it sadly. The destruction I've wrought.
Look at what you did.
And I look at you like, is he not?
I'm trying to think of other registries that they could recently arrested, or...
Look, if you think I'm an actress, you might want to look up, like headshot. I don't know where the fuck people put that online, but those kind of things.
Like a casting call kind of thing?
Yeah, like, I'm sure actors have, like, their headshots and stuff, like a profile.
They do. They have, like, for agents to look at.
Exactly. So you probably, like, know that, so you'll probably look up that kind of shit if you think I'm an actress.
I probably wouldn't find anything.
No, you will find absolutely nothing.
Do you have names?
Oh, yes. I'm Remy. I just need to make sure I didn't have a different name right now. I'm Remy. This is... I don't know your name.
Why?
This is Spy.
Are those actual names? Nicknames?
Their names.
What are your last names?
What are your last names?
Wisp. What's your last name? Do I remember what my name is? At least I have one.
Yeah. What's my last name? Figure it out.
I'm not telling you what my last name is, though I know it.
I think it's like... I'm Oberland.
Oberland?
Oberland.
Well, look at that name, I guess. Look at that name.
I think my first name is probably not Remy. It's probably like a short form of what it is, but... Yeah,
but just the last name. It's like family. Yeah. Oberland. Registry.
There's a few Oberlands in the city.
Shit.
Well, a six-year-old has gone missing. Isn't an Oberland?
Nope. Six-year-old's not gone missing.
Oh, yeah, you have a fetch.
Should have tried to haul this computer back up and see if I can get it working again.
I'm gonna knock it back off the desk again if you let me.
I'm gonna shove you over if you try to do that. It's like, no. Facebook. Oberland, name of the town. Kind of flip through and try to,
Yeah, there's a couple on Facebook.
Yeah, I'm gonna look at, like, the different profiles and be like, do any of these look familiar to you?
Alright, there's one dude who is, an arts major at the university.
I have mummies.
He also works at the coffee shop.
Okay.
Shit, you don't recognize him. There's a woman who works at a sporting goods store and also recently got back from China. You don't recognize her. And then there are two of them that have the same profile picture of, like, a little six-year-old daughter named, like, Remy or some shit.
Hey!
You recognize them.
Hey, that's my mummies. Am I me?
Look at their relationship status and families.
Married, they have a daughter.
These are your parents?
Those are my mummies, and that's my me.
The child picture.
It's like a kid. Could be her if 19 years went by. You're not a fucking scientist.
So, is that like your little sister, or...
I'm gonna lean over your shoulder to look at the computer and then look at Remy.
That's me.
I see.
Huh. I'll look at it and be like, yeah, that's my me. And there's our house! There's our house!
Background of the pictures is a playground.
That's the casting call! That's the casting call!
You got taken from a playground?
Yes. I was playing, and he was a director, now he's a developer, he was a director. He came, and he put me in the casting call, and he took me, and then I was in the theater.
So shook you around a bit. Tire you out.
What about you? You got a last name?
No.
Helpful. All right, so this is obviously something very suspect. I just pointed this out. I'm going to use my eye for the strange.
All right. What does that allow you to discern?
I will just quickly bring that up since I have it all written down. As soon as this loads up.
I'm going to try to push out the way you can do
this. Pushes you back because, good God, you are not getting anywhere near this.
I'm going to push back.
What is wrong with you?
I want to look too.
Well, give me a second. That is,
Shut up! I'm looking at my dice rules!
Your character does not necessarily possess a breadth of knowledge about the supernatural. She knows the otherworldly when she sees it. By perusing evidence, she can determine whether something comes from natural or supernatural origin. Roll intelligence plus composure. With success, the storyteller must tell you if the scene has a supernatural cause and provide one piece of information that confirms the answer.
Okay. Go for it. Oh, you guys got your beat for escaping the hedge. So under character sheet, under beat, put down one, and then, you know, erase that ambition. Oh, what was your thing, Kevin? What were your ambition? Wasn't it, like, start a supernatural case or something?
Solve a case that is definitively supernatural in nature.
Okay.
Where do we...
Under the beat section, put one beat.
Is it tens again or nines again?
I don't know. Probably tens again. Oh my god, it's where health is.
It's at the bottom. On the left-hand side.
You fucking kids.
Three successes.
Alright. This scene has an aspect of the supernatural. They're supernatural. And the hint is abductions.
Abductions.
Supernatural abductions.
That could be basically anybody.
Kind of walks.
That's like, the way it's supposed to tell you, though, right?
Yeah, right. He gets up. He starts.
Also,
if
he's just
yarns
told
again.
You that we are supernatural, like us specifically,
so
gotta,
yeah.
I'm gonna go on your computer.
Right. He's not paying attention. He's
Are you logged into Facebook?
Yarns again. What's that?
Are you logged into Facebook?
Yes.
She's on your computer.
He's got like multiple accounts.
Stalker accounts,
basically. So if he gets blocked for by one. He starts moving around, it's like alien abductions, disappearances at playgrounds. It's starting to like connect the dots, basically.
You had a case for that disappearing old man that you didn't get a feeling was supernatural. You got a feeling that there was something weird about, though. But this relates to another case you heard of where someone came back like a year ago claiming to have been abducted when they were still there, and people thought it was super weird. Because they never saw this person in the same place as the other person at the same time, and then that guy stopped acting weird, and then both of them just disappear off the grid.
Oh. What is your captors look like, this director? Big eyes, gray skin?
He had a beard on his neck. He had a hat, I think. Like your hat. He had a purple clothes, top and bottom, and a tie. He had like a man outfit. It was purple. And then he had
a man.
Sparkles.
He looked like a man.
A vest that was red and sparkles. And then he had a coat like this one, but I think it was a different color.
I know certain image boards were written by a lot of people.
He was tall, And he was a he. And he was the director. I don't know how else to say what he was.
Okay, I'm gonna look up a like list of directors and see. He kind of shows you a sign.
No, no, let me look first. I've had a couple seconds while you've been over there.
Okay.
What are you looking up?
Okay,
I'm gonna
look up myself on Facebook on his account.
Oh, there's your Facebook account.
Okay, so my Facebook account's there, and then as soon
you're
as
in
I do that,
right now.
I'm in college.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess that would that be? No, it's only been 2 weeks.
Fetch oh, yeah, you're older, but
yeah,
the fetch is.
So it would be the same.
No, so it's all the same. You're posting about how you like Ryan Gosling.
Hey, Ryan Gosling. And then to hide the evidence, I'm going to rip the keyboard off, break it over my knee, and shove it under the bed.
What is wrong
the keyboard?
The keyboard, yeah. And then I'm going to be like, oh. And like, try to get it off the screen. When that doesn't work, I'll shove
the
screen back
still
down.
On?
Yeah. Because I'm still missing some of these connections. It'll come eventually.
Can I just shuffle over? Like,
the screen is still on, and there's a Facebook page.
Like, shove it down on the ground.
I just shove you right off the bed.
Just flop. Ow!
Back up. It's like, this is you. You knew your last name. Look, I'm trying to help you here, but you can't be lying to me.
There's like a post from like an hour ago on her account.
And the pictures, she looks exactly alike.
No,
she looks way younger.
Oh.
But you can tell, like, it's the same.
It's like 9 years difference.
Yeah.
As opposed to 19 years difference
yeah.
with Nicole.
This is...
I'm just, like, pouting on the floor, like, arms crossed.
You don't have the pictures, but it's you.
This is...
My me was way different. How come your me is so close?
I don't know.
So you've both been replaced by doppelgangers. There's gotta be a word for it. There's gotta be what these are. Pod people? Clones?
Well, let's go find out.
Let's go to them and hit them in the face with bars.
Yeah, let's go home. Let's go home. My mummies. I wanna go see my mummies.
This is gonna be fucking tragic.
We should go see my mummies. Like... They should miss me, right? I know it wasn't time, like time is for real or whatever, but we should go see my mummies. They're probably like, oh no, Remy, where did she go? She went to the park and now she's not.
Wow, this is gonna be. Yeah, I guess that sounds like the next logical step.
Excellent! Can we get some old people candy? Let's go see the bag.
Let's not. I'll pick you up a bag at the dollar store.
Okay.
Wait, do you have money?
A little?
Oh yeah, money.
How much money you got?
I'm not getting robbed.
See, I'm robbing you. I'm asking you.
Very
I wouldn't little. Steal anything.
Break
it. I'll break it, but I wouldn't take it.
I barely have this place.
What does that even mean?
As in, I'm 3 months behind on rent, and you were supposed to be my big break, but you're not an old man, so...
Well, why would I be an old man?
That's the question I've been asking since I found you two, so...
I could probably play an old man.
Okay, so
you need an old man.
How much money do you have?
Well, why do you keep asking?
I, like,
because
make
we
my
need
face
some.
Go all, like,
so
old.
We can get to places, right?
I can drive you there, just
in your Hummer.
We're not doing it now.
We're not doing that.
I'm an old man! You got some...
Remy, stop
old
it.
Man
you're not an old man.
He's so horrified by this.
She tried to be an old man. It didn't work. How much better being a shopkeeper?
It's like, okay, I'm gonna have you two just rest on the bed. Just rest for the night. And tomorrow, I'll...
But I want to go see my mummies.
Yeah, I think we should probably go now.
We should go see my mummies.
If you give us money, we can go and you don't have to come with us. It's fine.
I'm not letting you two wander out on the street during
it's
autumn.
Not wandering.
In the dark.
Well,
winter.
Where's this? I'm gonna point to the screen where the picture of the park was, but it's not there anymore. Oh, the casting call park. Where was that?
That's...
We can just go there. Oh, my house is right there. I don't remember the numbers.
Right, which is why, because it's dark... And it's cold, and it's snowing. You should just stay here for the night, and tomorrow. We'll take you to see your parents, okay?
Is night going to be like it was when we were in the car, instead of it now being morning?
What?
Okay, usually when we're moving to the next scene,
Remy,
it should move to the next
Remy,
scene.
Remy, listen.
What?
There isn't any scenes anymore.
Well, that's not...
We're not there anymore.
That's not...
Yes.
What are we going to do all
night?
I'm
going to grab you and rattle you, because that seems like the thing to do.
Hope so.
Right?
We
what
ain't there
are we doing then? What yeah. are we doing then? It's the whole night. What?
We got out,
you're
right?
You're going to sleep.
But you got to stop with the scene and stuff, because it ain't working.
Lay down and close your eyes.
She's like making creepy faces. She has like that kind of like smile again. She's like,
"Oh my god, she's so creepy. This is super unsettling."
Okay, it's bedtime now.
Yes,
I'm gonna lay down.
He's gonna just lay on the floor on his like jacket.
I'm going to pace around the room and stepping over you sometimes as I'm pacing.
This is nightmarish.
I'll like close my eyes for like a while. Get open them again.
I'm just imagining like your mask. It's like normal, right? Like you look like that girl, but like your mane just has more eyes painted on top of your eyes.
Yeah, I'll just like close my eyes. I'll open them again. I'll close them for a little bit longer. I'll open them again. I'm like,
Pace, crash.
At least go get some more food now.
Okay.
I only had one old man candy.
You had the soup, which you kind of looks to it.
I hadn't had any of the soup actually. I was putting it to my mouth like an idiot again.
Though I literally licked my bowl clean.
It's like, God, yes. He kind of goes over to the mattress and like tears it open, and he's like kind of shuffling around. He doesn't use a bank; he just has a bunch of money stored in there, or did.
I'm gonna, like, go over and look over your shoulder past you.
He's got like 3 tens in there.
Can I please have some money?
No.
Please, just a little bit.
Look, I'll get you some food. Just.
Why do you want money?
So I can go places.
Why?
Because I got places to go.
Where are you going to go?
Well, you can come with me.
Okay, but well, where are you going to go?
Well, I can't tell you right now, and I kind of look at him.
Why can't Detective Hunter, what was your name?
He's really mosey.
Wisp.
I say Wisp. While you
oh,
me.
God damn it, just kind of goes over to the computer again. Kind of, like, looks for the addresses. And scribbles them down into a paper and kind of folds it into a 10. He's like, if you want to leave, you can.
Do you want to come with us, too?
Can I read?
Yes.
I'm, like, 6. I could probably read.
You can
I
read.
I would have learned
19
there,
years
right.
have gone by. You're an adult.
I forgot that I would have learned to read when I was
You've
there.
Gone through 19 years of development.
Yeah.
You're an adult.
You've had to pretend to be an adult for 19 years. That's what we all do. So that's what we still do.
Did you hand her the money?
Yeah, it's just for you, the two of you to split.
So, we have our house, our homes. How come?
Well, he can come too if he wants to, I guess. I don't know, we gotta go now. He didn't want to go.
Okay.
Do you want to go?
We're going now.
Yeah.
I guess I'll follow them.
You're like, fuck!
I think I just tricked him. No, I don't want you to pet me.
Yeah, I kind of follow them from behind a ways, and it's just like...
Just keep
looking. Where are you guys going in the middle of the night?
We're going to home. I look at the addresses. Which one's better? Or not better, closer?
I don't know. I pointed at the closer one.
On the top one wrote down first, you mean?
Yes.
Okay, how do we get there? Are you going to drive us?
It's like 1 a.m. It's like, I don't think my car can make it.
Right, so we'll walk.
Okay. I don't know how to get there.
We'll figure it out.
Okay.
He's going to show us.
Okay.
I guess I'm going to go with them so they don't get, you know, robbed and stabbed for their $10.
I just have $10. I'm like,
I'm going to be like, can I have that, please?
Take it.
Takes it and runs.
Put it in my pocket.
Gets hit by a bus. So, yeah.
Which one did you write down first?
I don't care which one I go to first.
In the middle of the night.
That's the best time, honestly.
Do you have a strange, scarred-up woman in, like, a weird apron?
No, I'm in the detective jacket.
Oh, right.
Jacket. Yeah.
To wear being
nothing but the detective jacket. Nothing but the detective jacket.
Yeah, exactly. I took off all the metal clothing, so I'm just wearing the detective jacket.
Oh,
I actually buttoned it up properly, though, so there's that.
I have, like, a button-up shirt and pants.
So, yeah, I guess I just follow along and kind of point directions.
Alright.
So you guys walking, driving, busing?
Walking, yeah.
You're gonna walk all the way to your house.
He probably pays for a bus at this point. It's just like,
buses are running this late? Fuck you.
It's only 1 in the big morning.
City. 1 in the morning? Nah, no, it's snowing and shit. The buses are done, brah.
Alright.
Limited service in this kind of rough winter.
Gonna try to get the car going then.
I was gonna say, I don't think you're gonna spring for a cab. That seems exorbitant.
That wouldn't be. We'd get like 2 blocks. So yeah, I guess I just tried to get the car going. The car that's running on barely any gas.
Okay, so you go outside the fire escape and you notice something.
What do I notice?
Something's creeping around by your Hummer.
Bottle kids again.
Bottle kids!
Alright, I'm gonna try to start creeping down the ladder.
Roll dexterity plus stealth.
Okay.
Stealth is a skill? Oh, thank Christ, it actually is a skill in New WoD.
It is.
I was bluffing. So if you're unskilled with stealth, you get a -1 to your die pool.
I'm going to also crouch and try to be stealth. You know, when you're playing, like, follow it, and you crouch, your companions crouch with you. They're probably not as good as any of you are, though.
Oh, huh.
Companions are god-awful at everything in Fallout.
2 successes.
Okay.
Oh yeah, I guess I should roll. Sorry, it was stealth plus what?
Stealth plus dexterity.
Oh, I'm really good at this.
What's the dice roller?
Kevin, text through the dice roller on Facebook.
It's literally just type in roll the darkness, dice roller. And it'll be the first result.
Don't fudge it up.
Okay.
Yeah.
I got 3 successes.
Okay.
I wasn't prepared. Dex and stealth, stuff?
Yeah. So yeah, you type your name and your action and the board. Which is nice.
Okay, you guys creep down the rickety fire escape ladder to get closer to the Humvee. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's a shadowed, slender figure lurking about, like, moving under the Humvee and, like, holding something in their hand, but it's hard to see what they are until you get a bit closer.
Okay. I'm gonna try to grab this guy from behind. More specifically, the arm that's carrying something.
Okay. This is a Humvee, so probably a security on it. Like the whoop whoop.
Yeah, this is like a shitty Humvee, though.
Oh, all of them have that stuff. Yeah. Plus, you bought it secondhand from, you know, soccer moms who couldn't afford it anymore after 2008 happened.
That's true.
They stopped making Humvees after Hummers after financial meltdown.
Yeah.
No one could afford this shit. All right, so you guys creep closer, and, like, it, like, as it's coming up from under the
Humvee from the front, it, like, pulls down on the shocks a bit. And the whole thing rattles a bit, and it starts going off in the middle of the night, like, wow, 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 wow. So, it's like, it stumbles back as, like, the headlights flash it, and, you guys see what it is. So, to you, it looks like this really skeezy-looking, bald, homeless guy. To you guys, it is a pallid gray man with slender figures and pointed teeth and giant black eyes like a gray, holding on to a ball of twine and twigs and, charms in its hand.
Casting call! Casting call! I'm gonna run up the stairs.
I'm gonna go take it out.
Get away!
I'm going to parkour the rest of the way down, if I'm not all the way down yet, and then I'm going to take it out of the ankles.
Okay, go for it.
You want me to run for that? I run up the stairs and I run back down the stairs and hide behind him.
What do you want for your roll?
What, dex plus brawl, or dex plus athletics? Don't fudge up. You're supposed to be really good at this.
Load. Much slower. So, Wi-Fi.
That's so Wi-Fi.
Should be just the first result, then.
And it didn't come up yet. Three successes.
Alright, what's off? So yeah, you slide down the ice and slick fire escape and tackle him. The guy falls to the ground, and what are you doing now? Like, are you on top of him, or what?
Yeah, and I'm like, what are you doing to his ugly car?
Garbage car from a garbage can.
Okay, I'm gonna slide.
Like, making like I'm about to punch him. Like, what are you doing?
What do you do, Kevin?
Pistol out once I get, or revolver out once I get down there, and kind of just pointed down at him. It's like,
dude,
just another homeless.
Stay
person.
Away, stay away. Casting call.
Relax, relax.
No, no,
relax.
No, the teeth.
What?
Remy.
Yeah, he's missing a lot. That's just...
No. No, too many.
Like, let my claws slide out, because I know it can see it, or I feel like it
can
see it.
Oh, yeah. It's like looking at you two, and, like, it's not painted to you, but it's looking at you two. It's like, whoa. Calm down, kids.
What are you doing?
I was looking for you.
What do you mean you were looking for me?
You guys tripped out. You left a signal.
What are you talking about? What?
You punctured the door.
You broke down a wall.
No. You left a trace. I was trying to find you.
Why?
To collect you? You guys are out.
No.
We don't want to be collected.
No.
Yeah, you do before
no,
the hunters find you.
They're going to be really mad if you collect us.
What, the hunters?
They're going to know.
Who's this skin job?
This is Wisp. He's the hero.
That's great. You guys gotta get back to the Freehold.
What is that?
It's our base. Why are we talking in front of the skin job?
What?
You're the one with the weird skin.
Yeah. You're the one with the weird skin. Cat girl, really? Have some dignity.
What?
You two doll face. Put some goddamn clothes on. Let me out.
I'm wearing clothes. I'm wearing...
No, I ain't letting you out.
Attractive.
Yeah.
So you start making more sense.
You left. I came to find you, and now I'm trying to bring you to the base.
Left where? I can't make any sense of this.
But if you bring us back, are the hunters going to be mad?
Oh, they're going to be mad either way. They're hunters. That's their job.
Well, I don't think I want to go back if they're
going
to be mad.
You're not going to go back. You're never going back. That place is shit.
Well,
We're not.
Oh my god, I can't do the battered housewives thing.
We're not going back to the theater. We're not going back to the theater?
No, that was shit. That was a hostage thing.
Okay, so we're going to... Where are we going?
Can he come with us?
Yeah, Wisp should come with us.
No, look at him. He's all normal and shit.
But he's helping us. He can't
deal with this.
He's
he gave me $10.
Yeah. And he's going to take me to see my mommies. What did he
trade you the $10 for?
Don't be looking at me like that.
He's going to take me to see my mommies.
No, okay, whoa. Everyone.
That's what they always say.
Just let's not start going to our homes now that we're free.
But that's a bad idea.
But that's the point, right?
Oh, okay,
We're not in the theater anymore, so I'm going to go see my mommies.
Oh, yeah, and what if, as far as they're concerned, you've never left? You're just gonna go tell them that you're their kid. They're not gonna believe you because their kid's always there. Or what if, as far as they know, you died? Well, you're their kid back from the dead. No. You need to talk to the king and queen. All right, they'll be able to help you out. They're used to this stuff.
Gosh, I'm gonna lean in and be like, "Are you being serious?
There is a king!
Oh my god.
Yeah.
So we go with you, but we can't bring Wiz.
Look, I'm not letting him take you alone.
I don't know if I want to go.
Well, you can't go home.
Okay,
that's the first place they'll look for you.
But he gets to come with us too.
Okay, let me up. It's cold. Come on.
No.
Yes.
No.
He goes into one of his pockets and pulls out like a little aerosol spray bottle and starts spraying you with water. No, bad.
What are you doing?
Let me up.
Smack your hand.
Yeah, he's spraying.
But it's like enough that you can wriggle out.
Yeah,
like,
he gets off. He gets up. He straightens his gangly little arms. This kind of gray paunch he has. He looks like a creepy sectoid. Sectoid.
I thought she looked like a creepy sex toy.
No, look up sectoid.
I know what you meant.
Good.
So we're gonna go see the king?
Yeah.
Who are you again?
I didn't give you my name.
Okay, what is it? You're really sassy.
I got tackled. What asshole drives a Hummer in this economy?
I can't afford anything else. I got this like third
hand. Oh, but you can afford to kill the environment. Oh yeah, let's just make winter.
You're gonna start that with me.
Winter last forever. You know.
Yeah, you creepy little homeless.
I bet you don't even recycle.
I don't even eat out of plastic shit. What do I have to recycle? You think I can afford a newspaper subscription?
Who buys newspapers?
Exactly.
He had a computer.
I had a computer.
I said I was sorry.
Alright, what's your story, skin job?
What do you mean, what's my story?
Well, what's your thing? How'd you stumble out of these two? The place that they came out of is not easy to get into. Unless you're looking for trouble.
I'm a private investigator. I investigate supernatural phenomena.
Aww, you're a Mulder?
Yeah.
Gross.
And I went down an elevator, found these two in this room. Look, this isn't my first stumble on with weird shit, but these two are just...
Yeah, okay, so you're not season one Mulder. Ooh, that makes it so much better, Duchovny. Fine, whatever, we can bring him.
Okay.
Wait, no. You have a piece, right? Can I see the bullets?
What's up?
Can you put them into his hand?
It's iron.
Is all cold iron?
Yeah.
Oh, are you fucking kidding me? Cold iron bullets. Oh. He like throws in the snow. Are you fucking kidding me?
What?
You're just gonna walk into a Fae Freehold with cold iron bullets?
A what now?
You have cold iron bullets. You know...
Yeah, I know things exist. Things that steal children in the night. Things that... Are you a... You're a fairy?
You found two women who came out of an elevator in the middle of nowhere who probably talked about being abducted by weird, strange men and women who took them to a magical place that doesn't make sense, and now they're back and they act like total assholes. I wonder what kind of abduction story that is.
Could have been aliens.
That's where alien stories come from.
That was an episode of X-Files, I think.
I didn't watch the show.
What, you know what?
It was an episode of Supernatural.
It was both. What, too good for Netflix?
Yeah, I can afford that shit.
Well, you can afford the Hummer. But again, not like $6 a month for Netflix.
What, you're gonna guilt me about this now?
I mean, can't you ever never heard of a library? They just have a Netflix subscription for the library. What, is reading too good for you? Fucking cold iron bullets?
Are you gonna sass me or are you gonna help these two women?
I'm helping these two women. What, are you gonna drive them to their homes or some shit? That went down well.
Oh, I'm sorry, I can't take them to some magical freehold.
You should be sorry. Fuck, if you're gonna investigate this stuff, at least know better.
Slowly turning my head back and forth as you argue to see who's
standing in that. Alright, let's get your aluminum monster there and drive.
Be mine.
Do you need gas money?
I'm getting the front seat.
You live above a bowling alley that's been converted into a ballerina studio.
Yeah, I could use the money.
Alright, I don't have $700 to fill a quarter of the tank, but I got a fiver on me.
You said we would get old man candy first.
He did promise.
Are you taking candy from him?
No, from the bag.
From old lady.
Yeah. Old lady gave us candy. It was really good old people candy.
I guess that's okay.
I try not to hit him with the door while letting everyone in.
Try not to channel the queen and hit him with something else.
It'd be very easy. It's very slippery. You could hit his head. You could impale his eye on the Chevrolet.
I'm riding shotgun!
So yeah, I let everyone in. I shut the alarm off. It's
glaring.
It's a good thing that lady saw so many painkillers.
Yeah, he puts that little ball of, like, twine and charms and sticks back into his coat. Like, he has, like, long coat pockets, basically.
Fair enough, okay. So,
he gives you general directions, but it's like, follow the main line subway track, and then once you get to the terminus of it, you know, you have to take three rights, and then follow, like, the lemon circle or whatever. Like, they're very weird directions. Yeah.
Directions this homeless person would follow?
Yeah, actually.
Yeah, stop for gas, and I could buy a bag of fucking candies. Still. Don't get the wrappers everywhere.
Are you eating the wrappers? No, sweetie, he shows you how to unwrap it. It's like, come on.
I already showed her
no.
this.
I want to go in the store with you.
I didn't take wrappers.
No, I do not allow you.
But you're taking the wrapper?
I get out of the car, I'm going in the store.
Yeah, I'll do it now.
I'm very particular about this. Goes in the store.
You do not grab anything.
And I use my $10 bill.
Okay, that's fair.
And I buy jerky. But actually, look how it might be surprising how like she picks up the thing.
While you guys are waiting, he takes out a smartphone, starts tapping away on it with his creepy long alien hands.
Right, thanks. He kind of taps at the gas until it goes above empty again. He's like, fuck. There we go. And then we're off.
Alright, cool. What?
Good video about getting fall asleep.
No, it shows you. What about sleepy fuck?
Frown.
I can't feel gross.
Yeah.
So you guys drive for around. It's probably like 45 minutes of driving with no traffic in the middle of the night. And yeah, you ended up under the start of like the bridge that heads over the river that divides the town. So it's like an underbridge kind of bar. It's like all red brick and stuff, and it looks like it was a fire hall.
Okay, I guess I just park.
Yeah, there's parking. And careful, you don't want to take up more than two spaces. Whatever.
Because he's a prick and a heavy.
I had to go 2 hours in the snow tracking them down because the monster machine here carried you guys away.
It's like, he tries to park 5 times before finally wedging into like the small little parking spaces.
Handicap parking.
It's like taking up both sides of the yellow. It's like close enough.
This episode's sponsored by Humvee. It's like, no, my detective agency, like, it explodes. And, like, the car explodes. And you're like, eh. Probably for the best.
No, my detective agency, he waits for, like, the bottom place to burn up. It's like, why is it burning up?
Damn it!
Why isn't she dead? My lease.